Amber, Catelynn, and Farah. They are all here with their main supporters, and we're going to take questions from the audience as well today. So first of all, I just want to talk to you guys and see how you're all doing. Maci, how's things going?
They're going.
How's Bailey?
He's wonderful.
Amber, Leah, how's she doing?
She's doing amazing. She's good.
Catelynn, does it affect you negatively to hear the other girls talking about their kids?
Sometimes it gets to me.
Yeah.
But I'm happy where I'm at, and I'm happy where Carly's at, so.
Have you had any recent contact? Pictures?
Like a couple months ago.
Okay. We'll talk more about that as we get going here. It's your life, guys.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Pretty moving.
Yeah.
When do you guys plan to get married?
Oh, not for a while. Not for a long time.
Now we're done with college and stuff. And
all right, do you guys ever fight and argue these days?
You know, she gets on my nerves, I get on her nerves a little bit.
We don't really fight. We just bicker. Like a big Tyler, you're getting annoying.
Catelynn, you're getting on my nerves.
Yeah.
You know, it's just like.
Do you think your relationship would be different if you had a baby waking you up all night long?
We wouldn't be together. I don't think we would be together.
I honestly do not think we'd be together.
So of the piece we just looked, what was the most emotional part?
The fight thing I laugh about because it felt good to actually stick up for myself for once. The thing that gets me emotional is my mom apologizing to me.
That's emotional.
Yeah. Because I like to hear that. So that's nice.
Let's talk about feelings for a second.
Okay.
You really did sort of strike me as kind of sad when you came on out here. Is that sort of wash over you once in a while, even out in the world?
All the time.
All the time. And then for you, your moods, they've been better?
Yeah, but I still have my days when I miss her and I want to hold her and I want to see her. And plus, yeah, I haven't seen her in a long time.
Since the last reunion.
If you had to tell us what the most difficult part of this journey has been, Catelynn, what would you say?
Letting go of her, knowing that I can't be there 100% of the time like I want to be.
Has you guys' relationship with Brandon and Teresa changed?
I email them once in a while, but for some reason I've been really distant lately. I think it's me healing, because at the retreat I learned that some birth moms actually kind of distant themselves from them.
So it's a way of getting through the grieving.
Yeah, it is.
So, yeah.
It's too raw to keep reopening.
It's me just blocking it and, yeah, I'll email you and I just don't feel like talking.
But
right
when
now.
We talk on the phone and the phone hangs up, you know, we say goodbye, you know, love you guys, whatever. And then me and Catelynn just kind of sit there in silence for a little bit, like.
And you're depressed again.
Right. So it's kind of.
I don't think we're fully healed yet.
I don't think so either.
We're hoping to build this relationship, though, and make it really strong.
Do you now know Brandon and Teresa's last names?
No.
Still don't.
But that don't bug me anymore.
Yeah, we kind of got over that. I just looked at it as it's not important to me.
At first, they wanted a closed adoption.
Mm. Right.
So they've opened a lot to us.
They
changed their total adoption
plan.
Because at first they wanted somebody that wanted a closed adoption. And then when they met us, they were like, oh, well, this might be cool.
Right.
It might be a good experience.
You can imagine the adoptive parents might be a little scary.
It's very scary because, you know, me and Catelynn, I always thought, like, when we were in the hospital, like, I was freaking out. You know, like, God, this sucks. You know, we had to say goodbye and say, you know, hello at all at the same time. So it's really confusing. But then I thought about them, and it's like, could you imagine not can't having a child, getting one,
and
then
someone
getting ripped out of your arms?
It's unthinkable, right?
Yeah.
Remember in the scene in the car where Butch brought up the fact that you guys chose a good couple for Harley? That felt good,
That felt good, yeah.
Like, so if you were to go through it again, you'd put a child up for adoption.
Absolutely. Yeah.
What the hell's the matter with you guys that you're about to go through it again, not using contraceptives?
Right? I don't know what we were thinking. And that's when I was like, no, I'm going to get birth control because I'm not going to go through all that again.
Is there something you can tell other teenagers that are taking those risks?
Understand that not using contraception and all that stuff, it has consequences.
You can't think magically that it's not.
Right. And one thing I want to tell everybody is that me and Catelynn could have done it.
Yeah, we could have done it.
We could have done it.
We could have kept Carly. Yeah. We could have raised her.
We could have done it. We could have, like everybody else does it. But I didn't want to do it in cost of my daughter maybe suffering in a life that she was not meant to have.
It wasn't the right thing for her.
Mm-mm.
Right.
When was the last time you guys got letters or pictures from Teresa and Brandon?
Her 6-month update. Yeah.
Well, you guys know this, but our audience doesn't, that Teresa and Brandon have sent along some new pictures and a letter. And if you'd permit me, I'd like to read the letter and show our audience the pictures.
Yeah, that's fine.
You've not seen any of this.
No,
I haven't.
You've not read the letter.
No.
It's all new.
This could be good.
No.
Catelynn and Tyler, Happy New Year. We hope that you guys had a great time celebrating with your family and friends. We thought of you both a ton over the holidays and continue to be so thankful for your decision to have Carly and the amazing gift that she is to us. Carly's first Christmas was so much fun. Tyler, she couldn't quite run down the stairs on her own, but we did carry her down bright and early Christmas morning to see the full stockings and all the gifts under the tree, just like you'd hope for her. She is so loved by our family, and everyone showered her with gifts and toys. The most exciting event was that Carly was baptized in our church this past Sunday. With Carly's remarkable story, there was not a dry eye in the church when Brandon gave his blessing for her. We had tons of friends there, and 17 family members were able to come. We knew you guys would like to see some pictures from her first Christmas and from the baptism, so enjoy, and we'll send you some more at our next update. We love you guys, Brandon and Teresa.
Thank you,
guys.
Thought you weren't going to cry.
I was trying to.
Here's the letter and the pictures.
Thank you.
To take home. How do you feel?
Good. It's good. Just, I don't know. It just gets to me every time how they tell us how much we mean to them. It reassures me, you know?
What hit you the hardest?
Her face.
You know what got to me was the idea of her first Christmas.
I know.
Well, I told him I was like, my dream is to have her, you know, run down the stairs and look over the balcony and see all the presents. And
well, you guys gave her that.
Exactly.
And we gave them that, too. How sweet of Brandon Teresa to send all this.
Yes, that is very nice.
Welcome back to the Teen Mom OG reunion. We're now talking to the newly pregnant Kate. Hey, Kate.
Hi, Kate.
Hi.
How are you feeling overall?
I have my days where I feel like sick all day, and then other days are perfectly fine. So it just really depends.
Right.
So how has your anxiety been doing through all this?
Good, really good. I think initially with this pregnancy, now that I'm 12 weeks, I did have, like when I for sure had like the digital, like 8 digital tests that were said the word pregnant, I did have like some anxiety with, as in the form of like, what if I miscarry? This might be a little bit of TMI, but anytime I felt like wetness, I'd go to the bathroom and have to wipe to make sure it wasn't blood. Like it was more anxiety about like, what if it happens again?
So a little bit of catastrophizing.
Yeah, I guess so. Yeah, like it was more or less just like what if stuff. Like,
yep. When's the shoe gonna drop?
Like,
that's
what's
a normal,
going on?
Normal feeling when you've had something like that. Now the other big thing that happened at the end of the season was you sent Carly a letter. And what did you say in that letter?
It was just more of like an update about, hey, this is what's been going on in my life and with the girls' lives, and just asking her questions, like what is her favorite subjects, and just like a handwritten letter, you know, and I sent it with like stamps and an envelope and extra papers just in case if she wants to write back.
Oh.
And I'm thinking about doing that every, you know, like once a month, like even if she doesn't write back, because I feel like when she's older, that is something that she'll remember me doing. I feel like it's a very good form of connection, like directly to her. And if she wants to directly have a direct line of communication with me, she can.
And before you sent the letter, when was the last time you'd had any contact with Carly?
Before I sent the letter, we FaceTimed. Her and Nova FaceTime actually like a couple times. Like every few months lately, that's been a thing.
Aww, sweet. Sweet,
and
sweet.
So that's cool. And actually, Nova, for the first time ever in her whole life, asked Ty and I a question about adoption for the first time ever. And we were just sitting in the kitchen, and she was like, Mom, why did you give Carly to different parents? And I was just like, okay, here it is.
Wow.
Yeah, and we were just honest with her. Like, Tyler and I were both in the kitchen, and we just explained the whole situation at a 6-year-old level, you know? And just stated, you know, like, we were super young and described our lives and how we were still in school. And she was just kind of like, oh, okay, like, you know, and didn't ask. But it was crazy to me. I had to text Dawn, our counselor, and I was just like, whoa, for the first time ever, Nova finally asked a question about it. It was wild.
Mm.
Did you hear what she was saying backstage?
Yeah.
What do you think about that?
I don't know if it's all true or not, to be honest with you. I mean, I don't know anymore.
Now, wait a minute. Express to him what you think Bentley's feeling.
I feel like Bentley feels like you don't care about him.
Did you have any sense of that?
I mean, no, I don't agree with that at all.
But the mom is telling you that's what the baby's feeling. Before you came out, Ryan, we were talking a little bit about what it feels like to be a mom. And we don't talk enough about the profound pull that moms feel to their children. We don't really feel it as men quite the same way.
Yeah, I mean, I understand that.
You want to ask him any questions about what he's experiencing? Because you didn't really understand that he experienced something different than you.
Right.
It's different being a dad.
Yeah, how does it feel?
I mean, it's just like an obligation. It's like, I mean, sometimes it's fun. Sometimes it's like the best time ever. And then sometimes you just, you want to pull your hair out literally because, I mean, it's hard.
It's not the kind of in love with relationship that you heard Maci talking about, is it?
I mean,
you love him,
yeah,
but you're not like so in love that you
can't. I mean,
I
know how my mother is. I mean, I don't know if you could ever love somebody that much as she loves me. I mean, it's crazy, but I mean, Maci loves Bentley to death. I mean, she'd do anything for
him. So for you to come and go, it's a little easier.
Right.
It's part of the reason it won't work out.
I'm not saying he is, Ryan is not having feelings. I think he as a man has different feelings.
I don't agree with that. Different men have different feelings towards their child.
That's true. And so you think Ryan doesn't feel deeply enough about his child?
I can't say for sure, but that's what I think.
That's what you think. That's what I saw you doing on tape. Mm-hmm. Was a lot of bewilderment.
Right.
Like, how could you come and go? How could you stay out if you really care the way I do,
right,
or even close? Ryan, do you think there's something you could have done to make the relationship work out?
Yeah, I didn't always have to be an asshole sometimes, I guess. I mean, I don't know. I didn't have to do some of the things I did.
Would you like to offer an apology?
No. Because, I mean, I'm not sorry for anything. I mean...
Wait, you said you wish you hadn't been such an ass.
I mean, I guess if I wanted to make it work, but now I'm over it, so I'm not sorry for anything.
That's the point around which you guys orbit that makes it impossible to get back together. No one's willing to give.
I feel like I have, but it's been thrown in my face so many times that I'm just not going to do it again.
How have you done it?
By trusting that he wouldn't leave me alone again, and he did.
What do you think the fact that you're not together gonna do to Bentley?
I don't know what it'd be like. It's probably not gonna be, I mean, something that he's gonna enjoy, to be honest with you.
Does it cause you pain to think about that?
Yeah, a little bit. I mean, somebody else is gonna be around my son.
All right, let's go to an audience member here. We got Phil with a question. What's up, Phil?
Hey, I was just wondering if you guys are really happy now that you didn't go through with that wedding that you had planned on doing.
I would say so.
Would you have been more apt to commit and try to work it out had you been married?
Definitely.
Oh, yeah.
Hey! See, that's confusing to me. Really think hard about what you want to do with that. It's your child and the woman that gave birth to your child.
I mean, I know there'll always be something there. I mean, she's the mother of Bentley.
And what's there for you?
I'll always be there for her, no matter what.
Do you know that? Okay, that's something. I mean, if you think back to what originally you guys had, there's still a remnant of that there, isn't there?
I mean, if she wasn't the mother of Bentley, then I would never speak to her again.
It's really hard stuff.
I mean, it is.
Let me tell you something. I only have a very limited bit of time with you, and I can tell you my professional opinion is that somebody could work with you and get you through this. I really do believe that. And so I would hope that at least just on Bentley's behalf, give it a shot, if it's what you want. Okay?
So, Taylor, what stood out to you from this season?
What stands out to me most is Bentley is becoming a young man. I think he's showing the Edwards that he's found his voice, he has a voice, he can think for himself. I think every week when you watch a new episode, you think Ryan can't possibly be any dumber than he is, and he will prove you wrong the next week. I mean, that guy can really show you how big a piece of he is. But yeah.
Taylor, this is, you know, anytime we talk, I feel like you've always tried to, always been honest. Yeah. Are you frustrated?
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, y'all saw the clip, you know, he sat there and called my wife a bitch in past seasons, you know, the things he's done toward Bentley, kind of poking fun at him, making fun of him, you know, calling him a crybaby. Enough's enough. Grow up and be a man. You know, come sit out here. Don't be a coward. Come sit out here on the couch with us.
Fair enough. Once we're away from the reunion, do you have any plan or do you think you might reach out and speak to him?
I would speak to him. He won't speak to us.
Do you know what that's all about?
In his words, Maci is a trigger for him. And what I heard this year is that he doesn't want to sit out here because he's working hard to build a relationship with his son, and that's fine. But my only thing is don't sit over there and call her a bitch. Don't pick on your son. If you got something to say, sit out here and say it.
So he has had a dangerous, life-threatening substance use disorder. Do you think he's sober now?
No, I don't.
Maci?
I don't think. I don't know for a fact.
Again, this is our opinion, but it's just based off when he shows up to something or when you see him sitting there in a scene and he can't hardly hold his eyes open. That's not a place that I feel safe to send our son.
Moving from the physical to the emotional, you've had a great deal of issue with anxiety.
Yeah.
I mean, you've got an overwhelming life. What's the hardest part about being a teen mom?
For me, being alone, no support, taking care of her by myself, trying to go to school, work. I can't even get my GED. And I didn't even want my GED in the first place. I wanted my high school diploma. And when I found out that that just wasn't in my schedule as a mother, that's what hurt me.
Well, you've done amazingly well, given the incredible stress and the multiple things you've given up and the things you've tried to do, the things gone on in your relationship. At one point, you said 97% of the stress was the relationship.
Yeah.
Let's talk to Gary and see how it's going, okay?
Bring him out.
How you doing, Gary?
I'm good.
I saw at times during the season you were calling each other lazy. Is that not an issue anymore?
No.
Was that just resentment because you both felt so overwhelmed by all the demands of your life?
Well, I think the problem was with her not getting the attention she wanted.
So you needed to give her more attention?
Yeah, I think that's the big deal. Because I would come home from work and school, and then I'd take care of Leah, or I'd spend time with Leah, and I wouldn't spend any time with her.
Gary. You literally didn't put any effort into any of the relationship, even when it came down to Leah sometimes. And that's what hurt me the most.
Do you regret anything you've said or done to Amber?
Not being there, because there's a lot of stuff that aspired that I regret maybe that she's done. If I would have been there, that wouldn't have happened.
Are there other things she did that you want to talk about that was disturbing to you?
Oh, yeah, but those are things that are between me and her.
Amber, do you want to talk about it?
Well, when we broke up, and this is a tender subject for him, and I'm sorry, baby.
Let me talk about it, then I'll say it. There's couple things, then.
Well, I don't want it to be so elaborate.
No, don't want you to go to the hotel.
All right.
Well, let's let Amber say it on her terms. Go ahead.
I mean, one thing that really hurt him is how fast that I started dating people. When we had Leah, I mean, we were still in the middle of fights and everything. It was worse before that. It changes your mind.
You know, people say you forgive and forget, you know?
I'll never,
things that happened to me, I won't forget, but I do forgive. Like, with the boyfriend she found and stuff, in order for me to overcome how I feel, in order to be with her, I had to forgive her. And
how did you do that?
I talked to my pastor.
Somebody to talk to?
Yeah, he told me, you know, I need to ask for, you know, forgiveness for myself, and then in order to forgive somebody else. About a month after that, I had met a friend of mine, and he kind of knew what was going on. So he let me borrow his girlfriend, and I walked out of the house like I had she
was. Don't say that story again, for real. Go ahead.
And she was really hot, you know? I mean.
What did you just say?
I'm just kidding, baby. Listen, I found somebody that I thought would make her jealous. And all that night, she started texting me. And I found out through her brother and dad, she was crying about it, how I moved on so fast after she moved on so fast.
All right, she got jealous.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, you said you were hurt. How did it feel being away from both Leah and Amber?
When I would pick up my daughter, I felt so alone. Even when I had my daughter, I still was hurting. Mm. And Leah's a huge part of my life.
I saw you brought to tears a few times this season.
Yeah. I didn't want to lose, you know, this is my girl, man.
Look at his eyes.
For those who do not know, this is my only girlfriend ever, the only person I've ever made love to in my life.
Are you guys taking measures to prevent further pregnancies?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Already. If we don't have anything, we don't do nothing.
That's why I always have stuff.
Okay, so
I'm always.
So you're using a condom?
Yeah. Yes.
It, perfectly, without exception, every time.
No exception.
But there is a chance, Gary.
There's no chance.
I might be pregnant.
How would that be happening? She's not pregnant. What are you talking about?
I just feel it. It's the way that I was when I was pregnant. It's getting that way.
Whose baby is it? That's the next question, because I remember.
You know what? You better watch what you say.
No, I'm talking about because I use a condom every time.
Here's what I understand. 88 to 92% efficacy used perfectly. Okay.
How have you been holding up over the last year?
Hello. Well, not too bad. Just been weathering a nice COVID storm.
Now, I want to take you back to when you were asking Amber to live on your property in a modular home. What led to that idea?
We were helping with a lot of things already with her dog and stuff, which is very sad, which, sorry about that. But it just thought like it might be easier if we just lived close together, you know, for Leah could see your mom and just kind of had, you know, a lot of opportunities there. And then I was like, hell, if you lived here, you could save money and I get paid rent. So.
Now, Amber, how are things between you and Christina lately?
I do feel like that Gary and Christina definitely could help a bit more. If it was the other way around, to be honest, I would be doing so much more. I would have Leah in therapy with me. Mm. And we've talked about that before, but he just wasn't about the whole therapy thing.
Gary, what's the issue with therapy? Why not?
I mean, I think any therapy is helpful.
Sure.
I mean, I think, like, right now, Leah has, like, a lot of, like, and I don't want to, I want to be very careful not put words in Leah's mouth, but she just has a lot of feelings towards, like, her mom and all of that. So I don't know how to navigate that. But it's hard to do that when, you know, somebody gets online and always says stuff where Leah sees all her Instagram videos, whether it's Leah seeing it or Leah's friends, and it's like, it embarrasses Leah.
If it's bothering your daughter that much and it's rupturing the relationship with her biological mother, I would think you would definitely want them to talk together. I think Amber's correct about that.
Yeah, she might be correct about it, but she's the same thing 10 years now. She's still having her own problems and can't get through herself. Like, it's really hard.
Hang on. That's not fair. That's not fair. No. Yeah. That's not fair.
It's fair to me. I see it up close and personal here.
I understand. That's a separate issue, but let's not deflect, right?
I want a relationship to be positive.
Wow. You know what I want to say? I just want to say to everybody who's going through mental health and the mental health community, please keep your head up and don't let people like this put your head down.
Good.
Always keep your head up, stay positive, and love yourself.
Okay. I agree.
Because you don't want to listen to negativity
like
this.
Let's hold
this is not what you want to hear. The conversation you had with Leah was super nice, but I think Christina could have said a bit more than I'm a bonus mom.
I'm pro your relationship with Leah.
And maybe
I know you are, but I just think that sometimes I get pushed to this side. Obviously, she just said it.
You're right in the sense that these are very, very touchy, emotional, hot button issues. And of course you have lots of feelings about it, of course. And I think Christina would understand that. So let's not let that blow up into something. It's let's just say, of course, this is tender stuff.
I'm gonna do this, listen.
Yeah.
I'm gonna stop this right now because we're gonna end this. I'm gonna end this on a positive note. Thank you, Gary, so much for that. I really enjoyed seeing that. That was amazing to actually hear you sticking up for me. But your wife is absolutely horrible.
No.
And I have been so, thank you guys so much.
That's not even
Gary,
true.
I appreciate you. You know it. We've known each other for how many years? 15 years now. And I'm going to tell you right now, you are a great person. You have always been there for me when I've asked you to be there for me. You said I could trust you, and I did trust you, but I can't trust your wife. And she has sat there and gotten in the way of me and my daughter over and over and over again as you have tried to push me towards my daughter. So I'm going to go ahead and leave. Thank you so much, though, honestly. You have a good day. I really hope in the future that we can have a good relationship, but me and Christina, it's not going to be like that.
Okay.
So.
That's unfortunate.
Yeah. She's feeling she's like losing her child to Christina or something, or diminished by Christina's relationship with Leah in some way. And, you know, it's work in progress, right? I do think that I think a professional in here would do you guys a lot of good.
Well, but you were on different shows, The Challenge, Are You the One, on MTV. So what's the biggest difference being on Teen Mom OG?
Having my family involved, the baby involved.
How old is Ryder now?
19 months.
Gosh, she's so beautiful.
I never thought I was gonna be one of those moms that say the months.
I know.
I was like, when I would hear that, I'm like, what does that mean? Like,
right? So, because I do feel that you and Corey have such a great friendship. And I've seen you two before, obviously, becoming parents.
You saw
you guys
that
had
day.
Great. The day that you guys decided to make Ryder. But anyways,
You guys do have such a great relationship together. Why cross that line?
I don't know. Is that bad?
No.
I don't know.
That's why Dr. Drew's here. He could help us figure this out. We're in it together.
This is honestly what we're trying to figure out right now is, okay, we crossed the line, keep crossing the line, but we're okay.
Wait, keep crossing lines. So you two have been intimate since then.
She's not denying
it. No, not at all. What would you say is Corey's strong points when it comes to being a father?
He's such a good dad. It's irritating sometimes.
He's there.
Yeah.
He's present with Ryder.
And I hate saying that. I hate saying that the worst part is sharing, because this is what I asked for. This is what I wanted. This is what I prayed on, was to have, you know, for Ryder to have this dad. And then I got one, and I'm like, oh, my God, he's still here. Like, it gets overwhelming sometimes.
He wasn't around at the beginning, right?
No.
So
he didn't know.
He didn't know.
He didn't know.
So you didn't tell him.
I found out when I was probably 9 weeks pregnant, and I did 13 tests.
13 pregnancy tests?
I just kept peeing. I just didn't understand.
And you still didn't tell Corey?
No, I told the guy that I was dating, hey, I'm pregnant. He said, I want nothing to do with it. Don't call me. I want nothing to do with it. Hmm. I said, okay. I'm thinking, no way this baby is Corey's. We didn't really do it that long. Like, I was just naive. I was young. Like, I just didn't process it very well.
So when did you find out it was his?
When she was 6 months.
So is that part of the genetic testing for the for the disorder she had?
Yeah.
Having a sick baby, though, was very intense.
Yeah. I was...
That must have been awful.
It's like, I was so upset and blaming myself and mad, and I had so many different emotions, and I didn't know how to process it. And everyone was like, is it postpartum? Do we watch her? Do we do this?
And when did you come out of it?
When Corey came along. Mm. I say it all the time, like, he just pulled me out of it.
So did that, I don't know, make you be attracted to him? Because I know that you were so anti that.
Yeah.
But being around him in this capacity, did you...
We're not ready to be in a relationship. Corey's so young. He likes to have fun.
You're ready. He's not ready.
No, he's not.
Okay, that's not we're not ready. That's he's not ready.
Right.
Right.
It's got to be tough.
It's interesting.
Well, Zach, you're about to become a father. How's that feel?
You know what, Dr. Drew? It feels amazing. It's probably the biggest blessing, greatest feeling that I've ever felt. Just watching that gender reveal video at the end of the clip just gave me the chills.
Oh.
That's nice.
Now, how has it been living together? Any issues? Any concerns?
No issues. I wouldn't say any issues.
Yes, issues.
Tell us, Shai. Tell us.
Other than I have OCD, this is probably the main problem that we have come into contact with.
He is so freaking clean. Just so clean. He chases after Ryder with a Swiffer the whole time.
Yep.
Like,
yep.
You one day will apologize for giving him about this.
I'm sure I will.
Now, Cheyenne, how much time did you have, you know, where you felt confident that this time around things would be better?
I think the thing is, Zach and I were always friends, even when we dated from back when we were 16. We didn't have sex for 10 years. Zach waited a decade. So we've always had like a really strong foundation of a friendship, I would say, that we've always fallen back on. Did you just throw your hands up when I say you waited 10 years?
Yeah.
So people don't know that, but
not a lot of people do that.
No, they don't. But we're genuinely friends. Like, we were friends, I would say.
Even when I came around when she was pregnant with Ryder, that wasn't like a...
sexual.
It wasn't nothing. It was me being there from the standpoint of a friend, seeing that, you know, clearly she's doing it by herself, and I just wanted to give her the company, just be able to support her so she didn't have to do it herself.
What are you feeling right now?
It was probably the worst summer of my life.
Oh.
Yeah. Things got pretty bad. They hit rock bottom.
Is that the worst of it we're seeing there? Was there even worse moments for you?
There was worse.
What were those about?
It got so bad, we started seeing other people. I never thought that would happen. He wasn't giving me the attention I wanted, and other guys were.
It seemed like he was actively avoiding you.
Yeah.
Which was painful.
It got to where he didn't even want to touch me, really. Like, hold my hand, like the little things that mattered.
So then you went out with somebody else. Was that cheating, or you guys had agreed you were just going to see other people? Oh, you were cheating.
I wouldn't say we were broken up, but I wouldn't say we were dating. And then Josh, after we broke up, kind of had a one-night thing with a girl, and because he found out about what I did, and I realized how bad it hurt. And then we broke up for like 2 weeks, and I started seeing someone for about 2 weeks, dating him, and then I just miss Josh. That's all I wanted. Josh is the only guy I want being the father figure to Gannon.
Mm-hmm. And okay, so you see this other guy and then you date another guy.
Yeah.
Are we practicing, you want a contraceptive now?
I am on birth control.
Okay, what are you doing for that?
I have the IUD.
Is that for Josh or is that for the other guys?
It was to be safe, no matter what
happened. Just in case.
But when I got on it, I was not sexually active.
And your mom, does she know there were other guys besides Josh?
Yes.
Does she know how bad the summer was for you?
She was the shoulder I cried on.
So she was an important, important person for you this summer.
I just got to where I've made so many mistakes. I got pregnant at 16. Why not tell my mom everything? So I do, and it's hard because my siblings do not make these mistakes. My sisters both waited till they were married to have sex.
So sometimes when young people are diagnosed with diabetes, they get very rebellious. They don't like that diagnosis. It's very unpleasant. Did it have anything to do with that?
I think that is where it started. I found out when I was 12. Yeah. I didn't want to say it, but I was so angry, and I'm still angry about my disease. I spent hours praying, just please give me a 2-day break of good blood sugars. Like, I just want to live like a normal person. And then in the eighth grade, or the summer going into eighth grade, I had a Down syndrome brother that passed away, and he was my best friend.
So, oh, my goodness. You've never mentioned that before.
I went crazy after that.
How long after that were you diagnosed with diabetes?
I was diagnosed first, and then that happened like a year later, so just all the anger.
Boom, boom.
And I just went off the deep end.
Can I tell you that I can sense how deep the pain was for the loss of your brother, and you still carry that with you right now? You've not dealt with that at all?
I was just trying to stay strong.
No, I know, but avoiding feelings are not dealing with feelings, as you found out. Thank you for sharing that story. I mean, I see you now. I didn't really understand who Mackenzie was, and now I kind of get it. You feel okay about that? It's really tough stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah. How's school going?
It's going good. It's hard to drop my baby off every day. But I go to Cosmo school still for 3 hours and regular school for 3 hours, and I'm cheering.
So is it high school or college?
High school.
It's high school.
I'm still a senior.
And as part of the high school curriculum, they give you cosmetology training?
Is that what? Yes.
And do you get a license or after that?
Yes. This summer I should be working in a salon.
Fantastic. Now, the last I saw of Josh, things were desperate. How are things now?
I don't even know who he is now.
In a good way or a bad way?
Good. Things have never been better.
So, Mackenzie, get us updated. How is Florida treating you?
So, I love the weather. I love the people. I've met so many amazing new friends, and my children love it. And I'm opening a gym, and I'm teaching classes out here, and the business is just exploding.
Wow.
I challenge everyone to leave their hometown at least once to experience life.
You know what? People do say move at least once. It's a healthy thing to do. Mm-hmm. So, Mackenzie, one of the more touching moments of the season was when you called your mom's phone to tell her about going to Florida. How often do you leave messages like that?
Anytime something exciting happens or a big life change, I call and leave a voice message, or I'm sure there's several text messages on her phone of, I really need you right now, text me back.
Well, you mentioned.
Sorry, I didn't expect that question.
Yeah, you mentioned how it was tough to process this. How are you doing now?
I mean, grief is weird. It's really weird. I don't even know how to explain it. Sometimes I feel like I'm just making her proud, and then some days I feel like, I don't know what the word to explain it is, but it'll just hit me, and it will be in a really, like, bad moment. Maybe I'm, like, teaching a fitness class, or I'm in front of people, and something small will remind me of her, and it's, like, paralyzing.
You were saying lots of profound things today, Mackenzie. Yes, it comes in waves. It's often triggered by stimuli, and making meaning of it, doing something for other people, is often a way of managing it. So, Mackenzie, how is your marriage doing these days?
My marriage?
Yeah, we saw you guys fighting a lot this season. I wonder how things are now.
So you'll see, like, on the season that, you know, we had a lot of problems. And the biggest one was Josh continuing to see stuff about him online. So when I told him I wanted to move to Florida, we were separated. And he said, as long as I get to see my kids, like, it sucks what you're doing, but we left. I think that separation was really good, and then we were able to, like, collect our thoughts and come together, and he decided he wants to come visit us. And he always said, Florida's not for me. It's not for me. I'm an Oklahoma boy. And then came out here and fell in love with the town we're in, which I knew he would.
So are you separated now?
No, we're not. I mean, since he's came to Florida, he has stayed here.
So he's staying with you now. Okay, he's not coming and going. He's staying in Florida.
Right.
Okay, got
right.
It.
Wait, is this the first time the three of you have met each other?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Nice to meet you.
Nice
guys.
To meet you.
You too.
The three of these guys have shared experiences that unfortunately are way too common amongst young people who become pregnant, particularly as teenagers. They all grew up in households where parents struggle with addiction, substance use disorders. It's tough for a child to go through it, but it also shapes who you guys are as grown-ups, right? Let's catch you up. Here is a look at Rachel's story on Young and Pregnant.
You left me for 9 years of my life, come back, and then let me be on the streets for 14 to 15 years old, and then I get pregnant at 16, and then all of a sudden I have a baby, and then you want to, like, start then acting like a mom.
It's enough, Rachel, cool. When you need me, let me know.
I care about you as a person because you are my baby's father. Like, I will always care about you. I want what's best for you. Like, he's been depressed for such a long time. That's why he's even done drugs, and he's crying out for help. Like, he needs help. But it's really none of your business what I do or what he does or what I'm doing for him or what he does for me.
What you need to worry about is yourself and your baby. That's what you need to worry about.
And me and my baby are straight. We always have been.
Okay.
I feel like she tries to make us out to be bad parents because she was a bad parent, and she is jealous that her own kids are, like, doing better than her as teen moms.
Yeah,
like,
literally.
Like, I did better than she's ever done at 16 years old, like, you know?
Yeah.
Rachel, what are some of your thoughts right now after watching that?
Although nothing justifies how I do talk to my mom, which is something that I've agreed that needs to be worked on, and I have been working on for the last year, but there's a big reasoning behind the way that I was raised, and I've learned that all you can do is just break the cycle for your children.
I want to dive in a little bit about your childhood. just to understand the timeline of your different living situations. So kind of give us a recap of everything.
Okay, so whenever I was 5 years old, my mom and my dad were using. We were very malnourished, and I was basically, like, being starved. Like, I'm not going to lie to you. I really was. Like, I was way underweight. They would just, like, be passed out on the couch, and my sister would come over. My older sister, Mallory, always lived with our Nana. She'd feed us, like, birthday cake or just, like, random stuff to eat. And then whenever DCS finally did take us, I got moved in with my Nana at 5 years old to 14.
See, you don't have for at least for me, you don't gotta defend your. You really don't. It's not like I don't think you're sitting here talking about bad about your mom. I think what's interesting to me is that you said earlier that I don't want to look like I'm this disrespectful daughter to my mom, which is like it's interesting that you're focused on that. And people should know that that comes from something. It's not like it's either bitterness that you have or unresolved stuff you have with her or whatever. I don't look at it like you're being disrespectful to your mom. I think it's an even exchange of. Kind of like just bad communication.
Yeah, because we both talk to each other the same way, and we also act like friends. Like, the things that I can't even name on TV that we have done together before I got pregnant, it's, like, stuff that no mother should be doing with their child. And so I feel like that's where a lot of it came from. We were friends. Mm-hmm. We were doing things together that's, like, pretty much, like, not going to parties with people, but we were partying at the house together, and it's like, okay, you moved me in and gave me this big idea that it's this big party, but the way that I talk to my mom still is not okay, and I can see that. Well, it's
Kate,
not.
You've spoken to your family members about the intergenerational trauma. Can you share with Rachel what that was like?
I mean, trauma, I believe, is trauma, mm-hmm. no matter what, but I would have to say I feel like the things that you've been through are really severe and sad.
Yes.
And hard. I feel like just for me, the traumas in my childhood was like drugs, alcoholism, and I mean generations of alcoholism. And then also the fact of like people in my family not getting help when they're noticing something is wrong with them. And so for me, for that, it was like, I'm going to break all of this so that way I'm not passing it on to my daughters.
I feel like you're in this running phase of PTSD, like you have chronic post-traumatic stress.
Yes.
And you're running from a lot of emotion. Mm-hmm. And I almost can't even feel the pain, but I know it's there, right?
Yes.
It's right here, right? What does that feel like?
It's not anger. I think it really is just hurt. Like, how could you guys put me through this? I was so innocent, so tiny.
Right.
And it's like, why would you put me through that? And even to this day, it's just like I'm always taking up for them and acting like I'm not the victim and just taking the and just letting people always tell me that it is me. But it's,
They hurt you. I get it. I get it.
What would you like to see happen with your mom so that there is healing going on between you
two? I think, honestly, like we were talking about therapy, like family therapy. I think we need therapy together and aside. Mm-hmm. Like, we both need our own therapist and to talk. Because I try to guide mom in the way that I feel, and she just is in such denial. But maybe if somebody else could break it down for her and tell her that this is really how it is, and this is how she feels, and this is how you feel.
Have you told her that maybe doing this can help the entire family dynamic, which ultimately benefits Hazley?
Yeah, mom's actually down with therapy. We just haven't made the step yet, but we're going to.
Got it.
Good.
Well, Kate and Ty, any last thoughts for Rachel?
So one thing that I noticed is that you kind of have this motivation to break the cycle. I mean, and just keep with that like mindset and just keep focused on that. Okay, just like I said, be the leader, be the pioneer and for your own self and just keep that going because the long-term benefits of it is like, I mean, it's you're going to see it in your kids. You're going to see it everywhere else in your life. And I also feel like don't try to protect anybody. It's not your job. Mm-hmm. You're a grown woman. Your mom's a grown woman. Everyone's grown. Nana's a grown woman. So stop trying to protect everybody and stay curious about healing.
Great advice.
Well, Kate, Ty, and Rachel, thank you so much for being here. We appreciate it. I know viewers and fans appreciate it. So thank you all so much for being here today. And when we return, we'll talk to Amber about the intense therapy session with Gary.
Give me the kisses.
Yay, mommy!
Your mommy good sugars.
No, like this.
Mm-hmm. It's your birthday!
You accused me of lying about being on Teen Mom 2. I didn't lie about it. I was actually asked if I wanted to go. I said I'd rather stay with YP. I was more than supportive of your move to Teen Mom 2. Until you said what you said, I felt shaded by that because, first of all, I don't have to lie.
What did I say? I didn't say Hang on, let's find out.
No, you didn't say, because you don't have the balls. What you did was...
The last thing you said in my DM, the last thing you said that my mom was a crackhead.
She is a crackhead, bitch. Yeah, let me tell you why.
No, messy ass. Because I'm a grown ass.
So then, I mean, be about it, Jade.
Punk ass bitch.
You are a punk ass.
No, how am I a punk ass bitch?
We gotta support each other.
You wanna beef on stage?
You wanna beef on stage?
Walk off.
That's,
I'm telling you. Okay. I'm telling you.
Ash, are you serious?
We gotta
support each other. We gotta support. No.
When have I not supported you,
girl? When you posted yesterday about me and Bri online, we did not exclude you.
Okay, first of all,
Kayla,
let's
sit over here.
Let's just cut the whole entire. No. Let's cut the don't walk up on me. You bitches act like it's me that's the problem. I'm not the mother problem. I reach out to you about bracing. Do I not?
Yes, you do.
Hell, I reached out. I've never been anything but loving to you. Rachel, what did I say? I said, people are going to judge you, but baby, know who you are. You're beautiful. What? Kaya, what did I say to you? I said, welcome to the show.
Bye.
Whatever you need.
Bye, Nessa. See you later.
Hell. You're cool with Jade after she said you were a dumb slut for getting pregnant again? You're cool with Jade after she said that you were dumb because you were a half bitch, half that was her words.
Okay.
And I supported you. I've supported you. And I'm going to continue to support you guys. But I'm not going to play this bullshit game.
What the did I do to you?
Nothing, bitch. That's the point. Because
we met up last night and said, do you want to talk
the dog out of you?
All right.
I will beat the dog
okay.
Stop trying.
Okay.
Stop trying.
You have a bunch of
no, because y'all want to do this. Women
I'm not
going to
fight you. I fight you. My coworker.
And I've done nothing but support bitches. So I support all you bitches. Like, you and your two babies. You and all
yeah, my and my
I support
babies,
all you
right?
bitches. Where's the support for me? Y'all want to hold support all y'all dumbass bitches. I should spit on your mother face. Y'all got me here for this bull.
Do you guys want to slide down a little bit?
Sure.
Thank you guys for hanging and keeping it cool. It was a lot. I did not know that was going to happen. Has there been a lot of tension amongst
you guys? The Jade and Ashley thing has been tension for a while.
You had another baby? Whoop the do, bitch. We can all open our goddamn legs. My grandma died. Did you reach out and say, hey, how are you?
Kayla, you got engaged a bit here, though.
Because I've never had an issue with Ashley. I didn't know there was an issue until she, like, made an Instagram story. I didn't know she was feeling some type of way. I had no idea. And then me and Bri had contacted her. Hey, we think we should talk before tomorrow's segment. Let's talk. She said, no, I'm good.
I reached out to all of them. My grandma died. I was cheated on publicly. All this no one has ever reached out and said, Ashley, are you okay? I have gotten nothing but support those girls.
Give me the kisses.
Yay, puppy.
Your mommy good sugars.
No, like this.
Mm-hmm.
It's your birthday.
I love my baby.
Okay, so how's everyone feeling after seeing that?
It's just hard to see, like, one of those scenes. Like, I was really happy. Now I'm just heartbroken. I'm just heartbroken.
Okay, can you describe to us what, no?
I don't want to describe, but all I'm saying is one of those scenes really hits me hard.
Yeah. How about for you, Kaya?
I don't want to watch it.
It's too painful? Anything in particular?
The breakup part.
The breakup? Yeah. That's still pretty raw, huh?
Thank you. It was just a lot. At that point, I don't think she really knew what she wanted. And people might call me stupid, but it's like, when you love somebody, you're willing to be stupid for them until they get themselves together. And that's what I was doing, and it's just painful to watch myself go through that. It's a lot.
Brianna, how about for you? What stood out to you?
Well, I found out who my son's dad is this season, mm-hmm. and I feel like I was extremely vulnerable. I feel like that really shows.
Mm-hmm. How about for you, Kayla?
I think I really learned this season that, like, you cannot force someone to be a dad. And I think I was trying to force Stefan to be a dad, but I've came to the realization that my son's better off without him. And I never thought I would say, like, a child's better off without their father, but I think in some cases, like, that's just how it's got to be.
Yeah, I understand.
I'm not going to hit anybody, Morgan. I gave you my word.
I know.
Well, my understanding is that Ashley's feeling better, and she'd like to come out and join us. Is that okay with you guys?
Yeah.
Ashley, want to come on out? Thank you for coming back out.
Thank you for having me, Dr. Drew.
Okay, so Ash, did you have a chance to see the clip?
I did.
Now, we had a chance to see a little snippet of Brizo and you. Can you give us an update on the situation?
There's not really much to update. You know, it was a hot girl summer.
How are things going with Bar?
Good. Okay. Better.
Better. Okay, yeah. Good.
We're just trying to learn how to take our feelings out of it and just do what's best for our kid.
Right.
So, Ashley, I feel compelled to at least kind of try to get everybody back together again.
Let's kumbaya.
It's clearly you got upset.
I don't know their issue. I got upset because it was a bunch of fake going on, and I don't like a bunch of fake going on.
So do you feel like everyone's just pretending to get along when they're not actually?
No, I think there are some genuine friendships, but I think that when we get up here, it's like a, oh, kumbaya for the fans, and like, but no.
Do you feel excluded?
Well, I wasn't trying to throw anybody under the bus, but I mean, we're already here. Last reunion, Brianna told me that Jade was talking so much about me that Jade and her mom, are you okay. Gonna deny it?
No.
I'm not denying it. Okay, perfect. So, last reunion, she told me that Jade and her mother were talking so much about me, I never said anything.
Okay.
I have always supported these two girls.
This between us three was so unexpected because nothing has ever happened. That's why I didn't understand.
Okay, so let me apologize, Kayla, for saying I was going to spit on you because that was disgusting and that was uncalled for. I feel some type of way, though, because I do reach out to you guys often and you guys don't reciprocate.
I felt like in the beginning, like the first season, we were all kind of reaching out to each other. But since then, I have like, this is the only person I talk to. This is the only person that checks on me, talks to me.
Like, I'm not going to get up here and act like it's kumbaya because y'all leave me.
I understand that, but I felt like there could have been.
Y'all leave me on red, so it just is what it is. So
there could have been more communication instead of coming on screen and then starting the extra.
Oh, I just think you took it too far. Like saying my two kids, that was way too far. You don't need to comment.
I was speaking to Jade, and you didn't need to say anything, but you did.
But we don't need to tear each other down.
So guys, let's leave it here.
We don't need to tear each other down.
Because everyone's on the internet tearing us down, and then you just go on social media, you post,
I'm going to go out. Thank you all for being here. We appreciate them being here. Clearly, this is not going to resolve. A lot of it is the result of what's going on social media. Young and Pregnant returns Tuesday, January 7th. We'll be right back.
You know what? You're whack as for talking about my kids. That's
not. I am.
Girl, okay.
I am.
You. No. No, I think you're petty as for talking about my kids. You took it too far. You took it too far. You took it too far. You don't talk about my kids. You don't talk about my kids.
We're not doing this. We're not doing this.
No, you don't talk about my kids. Are you great?
Look at my kids. You
it's
bitch. Y'all know all the producers and y'all know what this is. And y'all let this little punk ass bitch don't stand up if you ain't froggy, bitch.
Give me the kisses.
Yay, mommy!
Your mommy good sugars.
No, like this.
Mm-hmm.
It's your birthday!
Well, listen, there's someone else we'd like to bring into this conversation. Also on video chat, please welcome Ashley's mom, T.
Hey, T. Hey there.
Hi, Mom. You look cute. Now, T, when we were watching on the show, we saw how excited you were when Ashley got proposed to, and you were so happy for her. So how are you feeling now about Ashley and Barr getting married?
I think for us, you know, now it's kind of just overrated. We're just like, get it over with and get done. We're tired of hearing about it.
Barr, I thought it was nice for you to, you know, tell T that you're planning to ask Ashley to marry you. Why was that important?
What do you mean, why was that important, Dr. G? You know how excited I was?
Yeah, I bet.
You got to think, not too long before that, I had her mom had shown me her ring. And I'm not going to lie, Ted, her ring is like,
my mom's ring is.
It's like, yeah, it's.
You see
yeah,
it?
Yeah, come on now.
You see it?
Yeah. So when I got it, I had sent her a DM on Instagram, and I got her number and FaceTimed her and showed it to her, and I was hella excited.
It sounds like he can't think of it any other way than including you in it, but it's pretty cool that he thinks of you that way.
Oh, and it's a blessing to be honored that way.
How is T as a grandma to Holly?
Oh, gosh. I couldn't draw up a better grandmother.
If she didn't help out for all of the time that she did, for real.
100%.
Because there was a bunch of times where even I stepped back in a way, you know, because I
don't
wasn't...
Don't cry, Mom. You know I have on lashes. What are you doing?
Holly was my dream, and I got it. My dream came true.
Hello?
And I got a dream and somebody's knocking at my door. Hi, I don't know who you are, but not right now, okay? Have a great day.
Wonderful.
I love seeing this. Such beautiful energy.
I agree.
Now, let's talk about a very important conversation you had on race and racism. Ashley, can you remind the audience about what you shared in the show about your experience with race growing up?
You know, I was very sheltered growing up. I was thankful to be very privileged. And so I don't think I really saw a lot of racism only because I had the money. Money talks. People were tolerant of me. It wasn't until I kind of got on this platform that I got to really see how deep it goes and how real it is. And I do get a lot of, we both get a lot of racist messages and texts and comments. And, you know, it definitely opened my eyes to something that I was kind of naive to. Maybe I thought, you know, we were just so far from it. How can anybody be racist? You know, but that's not the case.
Now, T, can you share a little bit of what you try to do to protect her?
Looking back, I don't even know if it was protecting. I think it was more of us just trying to blend in. And, you know, we had the opportunity to put Ashley in, you know, all white school. And I don't know if I really protected her. Maybe I did more damage by not being honest with her.
Well, Ashley, what did it do to you emotionally when you received hateful racist messages after joining TM2?
At first, it was very sad. It was very hard to deal with, especially because people also bring my daughter into it and say racist things as it pertains to my daughter. But as I've grown and as I've been on the show, you know, more and more and kind of been having this larger platform more and more, I've just realized that people have that hate in their heart, and that's the burden for them to carry because I'm Black and I'm going to be Black. And so, you know, if you don't like that,
until I bite
you can kiss the new girls, baby.
Well, thank you guys for speaking so openly about these important topics. Ashley, Barb, we wish you the best. Enjoy planning the wedding. Enjoy Holly. Enjoy your lives together.
Give me the kisses.
Yay, mommy!
Your mommy good sugars.
No, like this.
Mm-hmm.
It's your birthday!
I love my baby.
Shut your mouth.
Hi, Amber.
Shut your mouth. Do you understand me? Shut your mouth. Get the off me. Don't put your I'm going to stand up for my man.
Yeah, you should.
I'm bummed out. I left last night.
You missed the rockin' party.
Because, like, I, like, low-key didn't want to go. And then once I was already there and, like, ready, I was like, I kind of want to go.
Well, you were missed.
To be real, it was boring as
Right, well, that's because
Okay,
it was a TV shoot. So I get what we're really saying, Kayla, is we needed you there to keep the party going.
You mean everyone was going to start arguing? Truthfully. Well,
who was going to argue?
Well, me and you don't talk. Me and Janelle don't talk. Javi and I really don't talk.
We're going to address this since it's just us two. What's the issue?
My issue is that you texted me telling me one thing, and then Javi's telling me another thing.
What is Javi telling me?
Javi's telling me that y'all are basically trying to be together.
So,
I honestly do not care if y'all date, and I told him that. But he needs to be real about it, and you need to be real about it, and that's it.
My whole thing is we can't tell you nothing if we don't know what's going on with us. We're friends.
Right.
All we are is friends right now, so I can't tell you it's going to be more if it's not. And I can't tell you it's going to be less if it's not.
This is so out of control that I'm like, first of all, Javi, they would not have filmed Javi in Orlando if it wasn't for Isaac going and y'all hanging out.
And things got miscommunicated. I don't know what Leah told you.
But what was said to me was that y'all were sharing a hotel.
I got a 3-bedroom hotel, which is like an apartment. And I said, if you're going to have Isaac in Orlando, you need to tell Kale. It's not my place to tell Kale that her kids are gonna be hanging out with us. That has to come from you because you're watching them.
Right, I agree. And he didn't do that.
Nobody was sleeping in no bed together. You're taking Leah's comment way too extreme.
Everyone talked about it, so it's not just
Nobody
me.
Nobody knew about me and Javi being in a hotel room if it wasn't for Leah.
Okay, well, you're the one that opened your mouth, so you can blame yourself.
I don't appreciate those.
So you did share a hotel room?
No, we didn't, because the hotel didn't happen because of Irma.
Okay.
So he ended up staying in his own hotel room. If you're still feeling salty about it, that's your personal problem, not mine.
What is there to be salty about?
You're salty.
About what?
You're salty. The hobby
about
is moving
what?
On.
I don't give a he moves on, Brianna.
Sure, I guess.
You know what? To be honest with you, I think what we want is to see you guys work it out.
That's why I would like to talk to all three of us, but without cameras, because this is clearly bigger than what we all thought.
You okay?
Yeah. People just got issues for no reason.
You're making them issues.
No, you are, not me.
Explain.
I have no
Explain issues. Yourself, because I'm asking you.
Yesterday when you walked in, you was really loud mouth.
Okay.
Obviously, you're the one with the issue.
First of all,
don't get disrespectful with my mom.
First of all,
don't
I'm going to have a conversation with her.
With my
she
mom.
Talked to me, so I will answer her.
Don't
I'm going to talk to her.
With my mom.
I'm talking to your mom. Obviously, the whole thing is just a miscommunication.
It is, absolutely. But if you know it's a miscommunication, how you behaved yesterday was inappropriate.
I had nothing to do with her.
Okay.
My fit was because the baby was here and there was no accommodation for him.
Oh, you said you don't want me or Javi or Janelle in front of your kids.
No, I don't want to sit around you guys. No.
Well, yeah, exactly. So you felt some type of way about me being
in
that room.
I was not talking to you. I wasn't
I know you wasn't talking to me, but you was talking about me.
No, what I'm saying is me and you weren't speaking.
Shut up, you're annoying.
Okay, well, you can be ratchet then.
That's fine. I could be ratchet, you could be bougie.
Okay.
How is she being ratchet?
She's telling me to shut up and I'm annoying, but she's talking about don't disrespect me.
If she's being ratchet, she better shut the up. You're annoying.
All right.
So don't call my sister ratchet, because I'm the real ratchet one.
Bye, Brittany.
Dismiss me, bitch, because you don't know who the you're with.
Bye,
I'll tell you that
Brittany.
Right now.
Okay, Brittany.
No.
Okay.
It's not okay.
Okay.
Because you're mad over your ex-man who you played like my sister. That's how it started.
Okay.
Yes. So don't come at my sister like that. Ooh, bitch, you don't even know. You there's three security guards around me right
now. Stop. Where's Javi? Where's Javi?
He ain't here till 2 o'clock. And when he gets here at 2 o'clock, then we go all talk.
Got some explaining to do, Lucy.
It's not that serious. It's literally.
You made it to this, where we are right
you don't
now.
Have to be, y'all don't have to be disrespectful the way you are. I mean, come on.
Not y'all.
Hey, what are you doing?
I'm in a dressing room with your ex-wife.
Oh, what time are you getting here?
2 hours.
See if you could come earlier.
Why?
Because there's problems.
Okay.
All right, bye.
Am I done? Oh, what the am I still doing here then? Thank you, Chris.
You're welcome.
I shall see y'all on the flip side.
I want to make sure you're all right.
Yeah, I'm not gonna do this. I'm gonna have a conversation with Javi and Brianna. Separate?
What I want to do is create a place where you go and you guys go have your private conversation off camera.
I'm not doing it right now. I'm not doing it today.
How can I be honest with you and let you know what's going on and I don't even know myself? Whatever Javi's telling you is obviously one thing, but whatever I'm telling you, you should take my word for it. And she was like, why is it so big? I was like, you made it this way. You made it this way, not me. You obviously salty. She's like, I'm not salty. I was like, yes, you are.
Nobody's hanging up on Kale.
Well, she doesn't know why there's so much drama.
You guys want to talk?
What?
We already
talked. She said she spoke to Kale. She doesn't understand why Kale is mad.
Don't even explain yourself.
So.
We already talked. There's no reason for you to be in this room. Y'all already spoke.
Okay.
Thank you.
Well, they're ganging up on her.
Nobody's ganging up on her.
Okay, well, you're all in here. Everybody's yelling at her. She came in crying. I'm asleep, so I wake up.
You missed it.
I'm like, what is happening?
You missed it.
All right, well, let's not hear this again.
If it happens, it happens. Don't be disrespectful. Because I'll smack the out of you. You're lucky my kids are here. You're lucky my kids are here.
Why am I
I'll smack you. Smack the out of you.
All right, but what are you coming back for?
I'll smack the out of you.
You came here for no reason. Everything was fine. Nobody said anything. We were having a conversation.
I'll smack the out of you. Don't be disrespectful. Don't. Oh. To be.
Yeah,
I don't want to mess up my makeup.
I literally did not come here for Jerry's for you. I just didn't.
People put that.
Okay.
I'm not filming.
Don't do it.
Where are you? Come out. Bitch, come out. You really want to try my sister in front of my pieces? You think that's cute? Because I'm okay with a grown-ass woman, she can handle hers. So where the are you?
Let me talk to the veterans for a second. How'd you guys learn that Jade was coming over to Teen Mom?
A news article?
News article.
Yeah, I saw it on Twitter.
Twitter.
They told me I couldn't tell anybody. They were like, right. You can't say anything. And then, like, I was in this weird situation where, of course, I want to reach out and be like, hey, you know, this is going on because it's, you know, different for them because obviously people are going to be transitioning. There's going to be new people coming. Like, there's going to be a lot of changing.
Even the Teen Mom 2 cast didn't know she was joining until it leaked online.
Yeah, basically.
You heard, Jade, how the Teen Mom 2 cast felt when you came in. They felt threatened, right?
Annoyed,
okay. How did you feel, Brianna, when Jade flipped over?
But it would have been anybody.
I was happy for her. I really, I think that her story is great, and I think it was just amazing for her.
Ashley, any thoughts?
No
thoughts?
I have thoughts on my own business.
So your own business, meaning?
I had no feelings. I got a bunch of calls about it. They told me they were going to move her. The article, I knew it wasn't an issue. It spiraled into some issue, but it really wasn't. I knew before it got leaked on the internet.
You'll have to forgive me. I just don't know anything about this. What escalated?
Rumors. Basically,
just a bunch of rumors.
There was rumors that it was between Ashley or Jade to come to two. And then it evolved and escalated into
me lying about it and being jealous, and it just was a whole, like, escalation of things.
Have you and Jade talked about this?
No.
And Jade, how do you feel?
Let's just cut the You accused me of lying about being on Teen Mom 2. I didn't lie about it. I was actually asked if I wanted to go. I said I'd rather stay with YP. I was more than supportive of your move to Teen Mom 2. Until you said what you said, I felt shaded by that because, first of all, I don't have to lie.
What did I say? I didn't say too.
Well, hang on, fine.
No, you didn't say because you don't have the balls. What you did was.
Well, I don't have the balls. I don't have the balls.
Chill out.
The last thing you said in my DM.
That my mom was a crackhead.
She is a crackhead, bitch. Yeah, let me tell you why.
No messy ass. Because I'm a grown-ass woman.
So then, I mean, be about it, Jay.
Punk-ass bitch.
You are punk-ass bitch.
No, how am I a punk-ass bitch?
We gotta support each other.
You wanna beef on stage?
You wanna beef on stage?
Walk off. I'm telling you.
Ashley, are you serious?
We gotta support each other. We gotta support.
When have I not supported you?
Girl, when you posted yesterday about me and Bri online, we did not exclude you.
Okay, first of all,
Kayla,
let's
sit over here.
Let's just cut the whole entire. No. Let's cut the don't walk up on me. You bitches act like it's me that's the problem. I'm not the mother problem. I reach out to you about Brayson. Do I not?
Yes, you do.
Kale, I reached out. I've never been anything but loving to you. Rachel,
the feeling is mutual.
I said people are gonna judge you, but baby, know who you are. You're beautiful. What? Kaya, what did I say to you? I said, welcome to the show.
Bye.
Whatever you need.
Bye, Nessa. See you later.
Kale. You're cool with Jade after she said you were a dumb slut for getting pregnant again? You're cool with Jade after she said that you were dumb because you were a half bitch, half that was her words.
Okay.
And I supported you. I've supported you. And I'm going to continue to support you guys. But I'm not going to play this bullshit game.
What the did I
I do to
nothing,
you?
Nothing, bitch. That's the point.
Because we met the last night and said, do you want to talk
the dog out of you? All right. I will beat the dog okay. Stop trying. Okay. Stop trying.
Have a bunch of
no, because y'all want to do this. Women,
I'm not
going to
fight you. Fight you, my coworker.
And I've done nothing but support bitches. So I support all you bitches. Like, you and your two babies. You and all
yeah,
this shit.
Yeah, my
support
all you
bitches.
Right?
Where's the support for me? Y'all want to okay. support all y'all dumbass bitches.
So, Ashley, I feel compelled to at least kind of try to get everybody back together again.
Let's kumbaya.
It's clearly you got upset.
I don't know their issue. I got upset because it was a bunch of fake going on, and I don't like a bunch of fake going on.
So do you feel like everyone's just pretending to get along when they're not actually?
No, I think there are some genuine friendships, but I think that when we get up here, it's like a, oh, kumbaya for the fans, and like, but no.
Do you feel excluded?
Well, I wasn't trying to throw anybody under the bus, but I mean, we're already here. Last reunion, Brianna told me that Jade was talking so much about me that Jade and her mom. Are you gonna deny it?
No.
You're not.
I'm not denying.
Okay. Anything. Okay. Perfect. So, last reunion, she told me that Jade and her mother were talking so much about me. I never said anything.
Okay.
So I have always supported these two girls.
This between us three was so unexpected because nothing has ever happened. That's why I didn't understand.
Okay. So let me say. Let me apologize, Kayla. For saying I was going to spit on you because that was disgusting and that was uncalled for. I feel some type of way, though, because I do reach out to you guys often and you guys don't reciprocate.
I felt like in the beginning, like the first season, we were all kind of reaching out to each other. But since then, I have like, this is the only person I talk to. This is the only person that checks on me,
so
talks
I'm saying,
to me. Like,
I'm not going to get up here and act like it's kumbaya because y'all leave
me. I understand that, but I felt like
y'all
there could have been.
Red, so it just is what it is. So
there could have been more communication instead of coming on screen and then starting the extra.
I just think you took it too far. Like saying
level.
My two kids, that was way too far. You don't need
to
comment.
I was speaking to Jade and you didn't need to say anything, but you did.
Because that, we don't need to tear each other down.
So guys, let's leave it here.
We don't need to tear each other down.
Because everyone's on the internet tearing us down and then you just go on social media, you post.
I'm gonna go
everybody.
Out. Thank you all for being here.
Everybody.
We appreciate them being here. Clearly, this is not going to resolve. A lot of it is the result of what's going on social media. Young and Pregnant returns Tuesday, January 7th. We'll be right back.
You know what? You're whack as for talking about my kids. That's
I am.
Girl, okay.
I am.
No. No, I think you're petty as for talking about my kids. You took it too far. You took it too far. You took it too far. You don't talk about my kids. You don't talk about my kids.
We're not doing this. We're not doing this.
No, you don't talk about my kids. We're not doing this. All you great fucking care of my kids.
You bitch. Y'all know. All the producers and y'all know what this is. And y'all let this little punk ass bitch. Don't stand up if you ain't froggy, bitch.
He's not being an Amber or being a Maci or being a Catelynn and saying you're going to beat somebody's ass, you're going to create fights. Like, Simon's not even doing that.
I think
it's one thing.
Well, I heard you called somebody a pedophile.
Well, I'm sorry that
probably
looks like
in
it.
In fun? I wouldn't take that as fun if I were the object.
Well,
you
got to have a sense of humor then.
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
They act like they have a sense of humor, maybe not.
And so why, and you're saying somebody threatened somebody?
Over the extension of trying to have a relationship with somebody who I do a show with and I share commonality through the years, it just continues.
No, that bitch.
Uh-oh.
That bitch. Say that.
So this
say
is
that
an example.
Listen to me right
Amber,
now.
Amber.
This is the example.
Amber.
Just because somebody's 20 years older than me doesn't
Amber.
Mean pedophile.
Hi, Amber.
Shut your mouth.
Hi, Amber.
Shut your mouth. Do you understand
Amber,
me?
Amber.
Shut your mouth. Get the off me. Don't put your. Don't put your. I'm gonna stand up for my man.
Yeah, you should. You should.
Bitch, you talk a lot of when people are around. You talk a lot of when people are around. Don't you?
Don't make it worse.
Watch your mouth.
I'm right here.
Watch it, and I'm right.
No, no, no.
Here,
no, 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 no.
And I'm right here. Watch your mouth.
Can somebody please take care of?
Watch your mouth.
And this is why.
Don't call my man a pedophile.
I don't associate.
Michael, do not get into this.
No, 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 no.
Are you guys kidding me?
Security.
They got it.
Don't
speak of me again. Stand. Don't ever speak of me again. Do something. Do something.
No, both of the criminals will do.
Do something. Yes, that's right, my felon. But I say to your face.
I didn't tell.
Bitch, do it then.
I already
know. Do it then. Do it then.
Come on, here, Amber.
I didn't hit him.
Come on.
Go.
Michael, do you want to call the police on the criminals? Because they need to go visit jail.
Remember, they're safe inside.
That's
here.
Right.
That's the difference.
And look at me now.
You
bitch. Oh, that's why you've been hiding all day from us.
Prime example.
Bitch.
Good job.
Thank you for the example, Amber.
Shut the up.
Dude, this is so
trashy
funny.
Bitch. Trashy bitch.
That's called a woman, bitch.
Okay.
You're not.
That's called a real woman, bitch. A real woman.
One of the main storylines that we watched this season was an ongoing feud between Kailyn and Brianna. When the cast came together in New York, Kailyn and Brianna agreed to sit down for what was supposed to be a chance to make peace. Unfortunately, that's not what happened.
Bitch, stay the away.
You're loud.
Bitch, stay the way, okay?
So Kailyn and Brianna took some time to let the dust settle, and eventually the entire cast came downstairs so we could begin shooting, but the drama spilled over into the studio.
Let's give a warm welcome to Leah, Kailyn, Chelsea, Bob, Joe, Brittany.
We have to play as close as they can possibly.
For what?
Just we want everybody to be safe, for everything to play fair, and so on everything.
We're gonna have fun. This is Unseen Mamas, show. For Christ's sake. This
no,
is
it's a, not fun.
What are
you?
I'm good. How are you doing?
Good. Nice seeing you. I'm doing that way. No,
it's all right, ladies and gentlemen, here is Brianna.
I'm not saying anything you all don't know out there, which is that Chelsea has had a remarkable story. Remarkable, since she first appeared on 16 and Pregnant almost 11 years ago. And as I've been saying, it's been really my pleasure to be a part of this and to watch her and her family and her evolution and her willingness to talk about her struggles. I'm getting emotional. I've not played the video yet. So let's look back at some of the conversations that we've had right here at the Teen Mom 2 reunions. Not all of them were easy or fun, but I think they did all contribute to this evolution that we've seen Chelsea into who she is today. Take a look.
Oh, man.
You guys break up a lot.
No.
Uh-huh. In the last 30 days, how many times have you broken up?
Last 30 days?
29.
All you see is the bad. And you...
Within 3 weeks ago, you guys were broke up and had a huge fight.
So we still fight. You're talking okay. Out of your ass right now.
All right, well, let's say that...
But nobody thinks they should stay together.
What are you thinking, Chelsea?
I just don't like being in the middle.
Chelsea, tell us what Aubrey's up to these days. What's the latest on her?
She's hilarious. Like, I might just think this because she's my kid, but she's like the funniest little girl. She loves doing her hair and her makeup. She's just so girly. I don't know where she gets it.
I feel like I'm doing so much for Aubrey, and I didn't get the family. So it's just gonna be frustrating when I'm alone and he has family.
all we focus on is what I have done wrong and all that. And all you guys focus on with her is what she's done right.
People call me a bad father. That pisses me off, because I know I'm not. And I don't have to prove anything to anybody.
Okay.
I don't owe anything to anybody besides my kids.
And what do you think is going on with him? What's up with poor Adam?
I think he's just an ass. I mean, I've heard a lot of things. I've heard drug use by multiple people, which I would not be surprised. A narcissist, you know, sociopath, everything. He does
not. You've been reading up on that?
I have been for a long time. I am just old-fashioned. Like, I wanted to be a wife, and I wanted to be a mom. You know, I wanted to have a family that was happy, you know, have a good, healthy relationship.
How'd you meet Cole?
At a gas station.
What?
Well, we were pumping gas.
Oh, that's what people do at gas stations.
And I saw him, and we, like, made eye contact, and it was really awkward.
I had always looked forward to getting married, especially someone like this guy. That was good.
What makes Cole a great husband?
I don't deserve someone like that.
You don't deserve him?
He's just so good, and he's sweet, and he's patient, and just, he's a good guy. This is definitely where I always wanted to be. I always wanted to be happily married to someone great. I truly can look you guys in the eye and say not one bad thing about him. Oh, my God. I truly feel like this year I have been through a period of growth as a person, you know, mentally,
yeah. And
in a lot of different ways. We want one more kid in a little while.
Yeah. It can be just a little minute.
He's got a big bite on his cheek, though.
That's from Aubrey.
That's a bite.
That was just so emotional, seeing the ups, the downs. Just, and also, can we just talk about your hair, the evolution of it?
No, we cannot talk about it.
Chelsea, I don't want this to be goodbye. Now, with both of you watching that back, what stood out to each of you?
You
first. Cole, go ahead.
Just knowing she went through that, thinking those things about herself, you know, like, you know, if she ever once thought she wasn't good enough or anything, it's just mind-blowing because she's beyond. She's beyond good enough for anyone. And I'm truly grateful for her. And, you know.
Did you like my blonde hair?
Loved it.
Chelsea, what would you tell 17-year-old with the blonde hair? You know, just some advice you would share with her now.
I would just say that you are good enough and it's going to be okay. And just keep going because it's going to be amazing.
Well, since this is your last reunion, I just want to thank you for sharing your life with us, both of you. I mean, yeah. but particularly Chelsea, I feel really connected to the experience you had, and I know a lot of other people do. We wish you both and your entire family just the best.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you.
We will miss you
so much for all your advice and everything that we've been able to talk about. Like, I know it helped me throughout these years, your hard truths and everything. So thank you guys.
Well, and the opportunity to do that because of you helped others.
We are gonna miss you guys so much.
I'm gonna miss you guys.
Give me the kisses.
Yay, puppy!
Your mommy good sugars.
Go like this.
Mm-hmm.
It's your birthday!
I love my baby.
What out to you after seeing that?
At the end there when Adam's mom called.
did you feel like this, oh gosh.
It's frustrating. And I'm not good at confrontation, but like this time, I don't know what it was, but I was just like, I've had enough. You know, she called me and I feel like she doesn't respect me as Aubrey's mom. You know what I mean? Mm. She feels like she should be able to make these decisions. And I asked her, I said, why isn't he calling and asking this? You know, why he doesn't call on her birthday? Like, does he want this or is this you? And her answer was, it's hard for her because she can't have family gatherings with Aubrey and him there. So it's like hard for her.
If it's hard for her, shouldn't she be talking to her son?
I won't understand it. You know, I'm not sure she fully is grasping his issues or holding him accountable.
Yikes. I want to talk about the designs.
Yeah.
How did this all happen? How did you start designing bags?
So I feel like since we've been on the show, we do get some pretty incredible opportunities. You know, we're very lucky in that way. But I always have kind of just like stayed in my bubble and I don't like putting myself out there. I don't like to be judged. I'm very sensitive. And this year I was just like, I don't want to have this all be over and be like, wow, I didn't take advantage of something that could be really great for my family, you know, and really set up a future for our family.
How did you and Itsy Ritzy come together where you're designing bags?
Okay, so I had used their products with Watson and I just like messaged them on Instagram, which is so not me at all. And I was like fully prepared for them to not even reply. And they're like, yeah, like we should look into it. And then it ended up being way bigger than I think what they expected and what we expected.
And you got out of your comfort zone.
I know, but I'm forcing myself to do these things that I usually would say no to because I want to better myself.
Right.
Part of it is you've got a great partner.
And the support of my partner, yes.
Yeah. What makes Cole a great husband?
Are you kidding me? I truly can look you guys in the eye and say not one bad thing about him.
We love Cole.
I do. And I am not perfect. You know, I'm definitely have my own issues, but he doesn't make me feel any less, you know?
Your anxiety, how's that going?
I feel like I've come a long ways.
You know what's interesting? This is the most animated I've ever seen you.
Yes.
I truly feel like this year I have been through a period of growth as a person, you know, mentally.
Yeah.
In a lot of different ways. My husband saw me at my worst, and mine would manifest as health anxiety. You know,
if I'm having a heart attack, I'm losing my mind.
Or like a headache would turn into like
kick brain tumor.
Yes, like, and
no one can convince you out of it.
No, it was a big step for me to accept, okay, this is anxiety.
It's panic.
Yes.
Sounds like you have great management, great outcome.
Yes.
You're more animated. I've never heard your Dakota accent so heavy. It's cracking me up.
Oh, really?
it's really cracking me up.
My flannel.
This is the most comfortable I've ever seen.
Yeah.
I'm so happy. That's amazing.
Well, I want to talk to Cole. How about that?
Sure.
All right, let's bring your husband out, Cole, and get some of his take on these topics. Come on, Cole. So, are you... Is this a little more comfortable for you these days?
No.
Yeah, still not. So he's good backstage. He's a hot mess out here. Yeah, it's the opposite of you guys. So we're glad you're here, as always.
I'm glad to be here.
And we've congratulated you on what you've done to help Chelsea and the kids. There. Just, well done, man.
I'm trying.
Yeah.
I could do more.
Oh, my
God. Not even possible.
Give me the kisses.
Yay, puppy!
Your mommy good sugars.
No, like this.
Mm-hmm.
It's your birthday!
I love my baby.
Welcome to the Teen Mom 2 finale special. I'm Nessa here with Dr. Drew. Sitting with us now, we have Leah. And we have Chelsea.
But Kailyn, Janelle, and Brianna are not here right now. The past few reunions have led to some major conflicts amongst the cast. which is why this season, some of the moms have refused to get on stage together.
So before we get into this season, let's take a look back at the reunion drama that got us here.
Are you pumped for the reunion?
Drama's for nerds.
Drama's for nerds.
Drama's for nerds, everybody.
Mary.
Yes.
Why is there not a separate space for the baby to go?
It's gonna be,
I don't wanna be around Brianna. I don't wanna be around Janelle. I don't wanna be around Javi. I don't wanna be around these people.
She wants to talk all this internet, but she can't say to my face. She can't say to my face.
That was just in her phone, though. That was just
talking.
Yes, and I asked her to come here.
Why are you acting up? Like, what is your problem? Relax.
You don't talk about people's kids, Brianna.
You bitch, you talk about me all the time.
And that is how we got here. It's a lot to take in. But how do you guys feel? What do you think about the fact that the five moms cannot get together in the same room?
It is too bad.
Yeah,
but I mean, I feel like it's for the best right now.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it feels a lot less stressful this time.
It is. It's been easier.
Yeah,
way easier this time.
So you guys were obviously here during the big blow up. Leah, what was going through your mind when that was going on? Yeah.
I remember you sitting there, like watching back, and you're like so calm. You're like,
I was trying to figure out what the hell was going on.
Yeah.
It was confusing.
Yeah.
What has all this cast conflict done to your anxiety?
I feel like my anxiety is worse now, but even back then, you know, I was so stressed to even come because I was telling the producers, like, I think this is going to happen. And they're like, no, it's not going to happen. Mm-hmm. So then I was like, I told you guys.
This was going to happen.
Yeah.
And I am out.
Yeah, I was done.
So do you think that maybe we could get all the issues resolved here one day? One day?
I thought you were going to say today. I was like, not today.
Yeah, today's not going to happen, but maybe.
Eventually.
I don't think so.
We used to be close, and there's even been disagreements, and we could still sit on the stage. I think what really blew it up was the fight.
Hey!
Hi!
How are you?
Come here!
I miss you!
I know! I miss all of you guys.
Tonight is the first night I'm hanging with Nicole and the girls since she and Michael wrecked my makeup networking event by fighting. I'm still upset Nicole has never apologized to me, and I want to bring it up with her.
Okay, Heather, seriously though, I'm so sorry for like making a scene tonight at your party.
I'm just really irritated that you blew up at a work event. Like, it took me all that time to put all together and all those vendors.
Yeah.
And I'd apologize to all of them and be like, hey, I'm so sorry, like, that's my friend.
It's Why can't you just deal. Not drink? You think it's funny?
No.
I was so in the wrong that, like, I don't even have any justification. I totally feel for Heather right now. She has every right to be pissed at Nicole for causing a scene at her event.
Ever since Nicole started dating Michael, she's been flipping out on people and being super fake. This guy is not good for her.
She had people text her and be like, what's up with this person? It felt so uncomfortable. Then her whole business could have been affected by it.
What else do you want from me? Like, you need me to say 100 times it's my fault? How many more times can I say it?
100 more?
I am really sorry.
I heard that Aaron was moving to Vegas.
Yeah, he moved to Vegas. Aaron can't provide for me emotionally and can't provide financially for his son, so now he's just running away.
Seriously, we need to get you over Aaron because you deserve so much better. I'm gonna find you a catch.
Let's be honest. Nicole and I are both single moms with questionable taste in men, so I'm not sure I want her playing matchmaker for me.
Brandy.
Oh, what's up, man?
So really?
Hey, guys.
Hi.
Hey, sweetheart.
How are you doing?
There's a lot riding on tonight with Michael. Ever since we saw a therapist together, I'm sensitive to his drinking. I do think our relationship can be saved, but I'm sick of having to apologize for him to my friends. So I'm not sure how many more chances I can give him.
A lawyer and a philanthropist.
What?
And a
Hold
guy
on,
needs...
he's telling a joke, guys.
And
Michael, I've heard this 1,000 times.
Oh, we haven't heard it.
We don't
want to
hear it.
Stay with
there's
us
a
on
lawyer
this one.
And a philanthropist.
Michael has showed up and he's obviously drunk right now.
And he said,
philanthropist.
Who uses their heart more? And he's like, well, the lawyer doesn't use his heart at all, so I'm going for philanthropist. That's the joke.
That execution was absolutely brutal.
Why are you acting like you're drunk right now?
I'm not.
She said things were different with Michael, but this seems like the same old pattern.
Can we get solid for
breathe
us?
Breathe on me.
You smell like fireball.
Don't with me.
Michael and Nicole just should not be together because every time he's around, he's just a hot mess.
What is this?
Water.
Let me try it. Don't water, Michael. You're a loser.
I know how Nicole feels because, I mean, I've been through it. You're just caught up in this vicious cycle and you don't want to listen to anybody.
Welcome back to the Teen Mom 2 reunion. I'm here with Leah and her sister, Victoria.
So, Leo, I'm curious about something. We saw you hit bottom, frankly, and you then started building yourself back up. And the first thing you did is you sort of eliminated all the relationships that you felt were toxic at the time. Mm-hmm. I'm seeing everybody kind of come back into your life. Mm-hmm. Can you tell me about that process?
So when I went to Arizona to the treatment facility, I realized that a lot of things that were happening in my life and the people that I had involved in my life were toxic.
You know, we never talked about that moment of how you became willing, because you were not so willing at the beginning.
Well, my book's coming out and you can read all about it in April. But Larry Musnick and the entire MTV family is a part of it, because had it not been for them, I wouldn't have had the support. I wouldn't have had anyone.
Yeah.
I'm glad you're healthy and happy and here.
Thank you.
How did Victoria tell you that she was pregnant?
I don't think you wanted to tell me, did you?
Not really.
Did Royer, do you think he wanted to get you pregnant?
I don't think he wanted to. To him, at first, I was just gonna hook up and go on. And he's like, but then caught feelings.
He caught feelings?
Yeah.
Does Royer have other children?
Yes, he has two sons.
With the same person, or?
No.
And
they are different.
Anybody up in the United States, or?
Mm-mm. He don't really communicate with the moms. His sons are old enough that he just communicates directly to them.
So I'm wondering if there was not some more intention involved with this.
Yeah, well, I mean, I don't
know. You had a conversation with him, though, and was like, because so many people were like, oh, he just wants to come into the States. That's why he got you pregnant, blah, blah, blah. And they had that conversation. And he was like, listen, I really don't want to come there.
So tell me what's coming next. Are there plans for Royer to move up to the U.S.? Tell me about this.
Yes. We actually hired an attorney to help us.
Immigration attorney.
Yeah, immigration attorney to get him here.
Does he need a sponsor?
Yes.
You're sponsoring?
I am.
Because that goes a long way to getting people up here, right?
Yeah.
And so you're having to go to court, advocate.
I have to be financially fit to vouch for
him. And to support him when he gets here.
And to support him, yes.
Yeah. Well, Roher couldn't travel to New York for this reunion, but we do have him on video chat. So he's there with his friend, Adon. Please welcome Roher and Adon. Here they are. So, Roher, you originally from Costa Rica?
Yes.
Roher, were you automatically attracted to Victoria when you saw her?
Yes, when going to the house for pickup, she is the first person out to the house. Look, her drinking coffee.
Roher, how did you react when you found out that Victoria was pregnant? Were you happy? Were you scared?
Really both, happy and scared.
Okay, so this is more of a question for the both of them, Victoria and Roher. What happened to using protection?
He had told me that he asked me about using a condom, and I told him no.
Oh.
But I don't remember that first time. So I guess it would be my fault.
It's not only her fault, you know, it's both.
Victoria wasn't the only one who made a connection in Costa Rica. Leah also made a connection with Roher's friend, Adon, okay? Hi, Adon, how are you?
I'm good, you?
I'm great. Love the hair.
right?
Yeah, absolutely. So how did you and Leah meet?
Well, I met her when she came to see Roger with her sister in Costa Rica. Hmm.
And did you know right away that you had a special connection?
Yeah, we are really good friends. So I can say that we have a great connection.
Yeah. That's nice. Okay, well, is there anything else you want to share with us about Leah? Anything that you really liked about her?
I'm really proud of her. I hear a lot about her life, so I'm super proud of her.
Thank you.
She's a great person.
Yeah, she's come a long way. How did you learn about her life? Did you look her up? Did you try to find out information, or did you just talk to her about it?
I don't really watch TV, to be honest. I hear first from Roger, and then when they came, I met her here, and we had a great time.
What goes on from here with Adon?
We're going to continue to be friends. I'm going to continue to hang out with him in Costa Rica.
You say it as though
you called him your what? Your Costa Rican what?
What are you saying?
Victoria, what does she call him? What does she call him, Victoria?
I love you.
She's lying, by the way.
That's going to be their private secret. We're not going to get to hear it. Now, what do you think the future holds?
I mean, I'm gonna keep being her friend. You know, whatever she does, I'm happy. As long as she's happy.
Nice.
Sweet.
Give me the kisses.
Yay, puppy!
Your mommy good sugars.
No, like this.
Mm-hmm. It's your birthday! Yay!
Leah, and joining us now, Jeremy.
Hi, Jeremy. Nice to see you again. So, Jeremy, you had a chance to see the clip from this past season. What are your thoughts seeing it?
I don't know. Like, sometimes I kind of wish, like, I took her to dinner. But every time I try to take her to dinner, something always happened. That was out of my control. So, I don't know.
Jeremy, I know it's hard for you to talk about emotions.
Yeah, I don't do it.
I know, but I'm wondering, was that feelings of regret that this didn't work out, or was that?
I got like a lot of regret. I mean, I wasn't like the best husband and like support system when she was like not healthy at the time. I mean, I just deal with it my own way.
I don't know how to ask this.
Just ask it.
Do you wish it worked out?
Why do you look at me like that every single time?
I mean, yeah, but in the back of my mind, like, what happens at dawn again?
Do you love Addie's mom?
Well, yeah, I always love her.
Yeah. And as much as Jeremy's heart is in it, yours isn't.
Right.
Doesn't mean it
wouldn't
I don't know
if his heart's completely in it either. I think you just want to settle. It's easier to settle than...
Oh, I don't think so, Leo.
I don't agree.
I don't think that's what it is.
I don't agree with you.
Yes, it is.
Hey, he's a doctor.
But I do believe Leah when she says she's working on herself. And I'm going to tell you something.
She's done fantastic.
One of the most moving moments of the entire Teen Mom experience was when you called her and told her congratulations for all the progress she had made.
Yes.
You remember that phone call? Just thinking about it to this minute, I've just moved beyond words. And I thought to myself, he is so right. Mm-hmm. He is so right. It's so... amazing.
And she went from like being really like sick to like,
she was in
really
trouble. Oh. Yeah.
And she worked her ass off. So like she deserved like a compliment.
Thank you.
Since things are over between you two, Jeremy, have you started seeing other people?
Nope. Not like, I mean,
well, like
I
seeing
got
people.
Friends.
Talking.
Friends.
Talking.
Friends.
Friends. Friends with benefits.
Easy.
Friends.
Easy.
Okay.
Jeremy, you and Corey always got along. Still getting along?
No.
What?
What's
going on? You guys get along.
We get along, but I just don't agree with a lot of
like what?
Okay, well, glad you asked the question.
Yeah.
All right, so she's the only one that goes to Allie's appointments. Corey and attend Allie's appointment in Columbus in who knows how long. And then she can't take the twins to their stepmom and drop them off. She has to wait for Corey. She wants zero to do with the twins. Zero. And it's obvious to anybody in the world.
That doesn't sound like the Miranda I met. No. Is she okay?
I mean, I think there's definitely something going on. I can't speak for her.
Yeah. I know it pisses you off, but there might be something underlying that explains it.
I just feel like he uses her all the time.
Uses?
Like Leah.
To take care of Allie.
Yeah, and Gracie.
But I'm going to go to the appointments no matter what. That's what I tell you. I'm going to those appointments no matter what. So I think maybe that's why Corey's kind of like, well, Leah's going. Both of us don't need to be there.
You still can at least make an effort to go.
just representing other points of view, I mean, sometimes these appointments can be pretty perfunctory. Like, you know, they do some muscle testing. All right, great. See you in 6 months.
I don't give a if it's a 2-minute appointment. At least show your presence for your child, man. I can't be there for everything for Addie, and it hurts my feelings. I miss so much for, like, my little girl because my job. And Corey's has a great schedule. He works at home, and he can take off whenever he wants to. I'm going to go fishing.
Would you?
Like, what the
Would you ever pull him aside?
I'm pissed about it. I don't give a
Well, I think it's...
I would never pull him aside because that would not end well.
I don't want him to be there. I think Allie wants him to be there.
I remember when they were very involved when they were in denial. Interestingly, when they didn't want her to have a chronic condition, they were very involved.
We were going through a custody battle, too. Mm-hmm. And it matters what medical appointments you go to.
It was to show face.
Miranda went to them, too.
Wow. So you guys are all in a good place, right, from what I'm hearing. So why can't you all be around each other or talk, right?
I would love to have a better relationship with both of them.
Yeah.
100%. Because I think that the environment, even at a ball game, the kids feel that tension. And it's almost like when Miranda arrives, Corey's entire family stops talking to me and we all separate. If Corey's there, like, he'll talk a little bit.
And then when Queen arrives, it goes
No, there. Not when Miranda arrives.
Okay.
Everyone kind of stops talking to each other, and it's like everyone separates.
I'm so sad to hear that.
I appreciate that you're looking out for the twins.
Well, I mean, what the hell? Why wouldn't I?
You ever watch this show before?
True.
So many males do not step up for anybody.
Give me the kisses.
Yay, puppy!
Your mommy good sugars.
No, like this.
Mm-hmm. It's your birthday!
I love my baby.
Anna has been constantly frustrated by the lack of support from her daughter's fathers. This season, both of them offered glimpses of hope, but also moments of disappointment. Let's refresh our memories on Brianna's journey this season.
What's your name?
Mother.
No, mommy.
Mommy. You look crazy, Nova.
Why aren't you around? Do you want us to be together? What is it?
Obviously, you know that I really want that.
I just want to go home.
Why did I have sex with him?
Did he use protection?
No.
No, that's what you up.
I do have your results back. The chlamydia portion did show as a positive result.
I don't think we can be anything more than us being parents to Stella.
I've just been seeing somebody. It's not gonna go anywhere. We're just having a good time.
Are you falling in love with him, Brianna?
I'm not in love with him. I may be a little infatuated and definitely in lust.
You just got back from Puerto Rico with your secret bae. How's that been going?
To be honest, we're under quarantine right now, so it's kind of hard.
Bitch got a $15,000 body. I don't even have $15,000 worth of.
This is why I don't like talking to him. Like, it doesn't, it just goes south so fast.
Brianna, what from this season stands out to you the most?
I don't know. My life is a hot mess.
I bet you're not surprised that we were all a bit shocked with your hooking up with Lewis twice. Explain all that to me.
I don't know. It was just, I'm going to blame it on the alcohol the first time. The second time, I don't know. Just happened. Will there ever be another time? Hell no.
So first of all, I want to thank you for telling your story of the visit to Planned Parenthood and the sexually transmitted infection. I'm imagining you were shocked at the results.
Yeah. It kind of bit me in the ass because I always get tested. Like, this is something that I just do. And I thought it was just going to be a regular visit. Nothing was to come about it. And for me to get those results, I was, like, super shocked and scared. I'm just like, this can't be happening right now. Like, not right now. But, you know, it's chlamydia. It's treatable.
Were you nervous about sharing this information with everyone, like, on the show?
Yes. This is something that's taboo. Nobody talks about it. Like, this is supposed to be a secret. But, you know, they filmed it, the phone call. So it was like, I have no choice but to talk about it now. So, yeah.
And do you know at this point if Lewis has received any treatment for his STI?
I would hope so. Who wants to live with that? Who wants to live with an itchy crotch?
Well,
I know
it's not so much itchy crotch.
Whatever happened to Secret Bay? Because, you know, we saw him. Well, we didn't see him. We heard about him. Was it COVID that just ended things or?
Yeah, COVID. COVID. We ended up on quarantine and we just went our separate ways.
If it wasn't for COVID.
Oh, my God.
COVID,
she's lying to us. I don't know what she's thinking, but that's not what she's thinking.
Well, Brianna, if it wasn't for.
You don't have to tell us, but I know when you're lying. Is he a much older guy than you?
Yeah.
Oh, isn't that interesting?
Yeah.
Can we not talk about him? He's not important.
So now, we have to discuss the ups and downs you've had this season with Nova's father. Coming to us from Florida, please welcome Devoyne. So Devoyne, thank you for being here. We appreciate you coming out. Nessa and I are, we love the outfit. We are admiring it. Well done, sir.
Sharp.
Thank you.
What are you doing for work right now? Are you working?
Yeah, I still serve Bonefish Grill.
That's going good?
It's going as good as it can go, you know, I mean.
Because of COVID, it's slow?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. It was busy season and then COVID hit and, you know, we're just taking what we can get.
So, Devoyne, it seemed like you got a bit defensive when Brianna asked for financial support this last time. What was that about?
I mean, I just stating the obvious.
What's that?
I mean, the obvious is on black and white. It's on paper. Like, we can bring out a salary, how much money you've made, how much I've made. It's a major, it's not even close.
I don't think it's fair that you count what I make or what I don't make because at the end of the day, we both made Nova together and it's not fair that I'm doing everything by myself.
All right, now you make all those decisions you do. You don't look up what's financially efficient for me and you. You make that decision on your salary. You do not consult with me before you sign her name on something. You never do, ever. And when a fan and COVID came and I'm not making no money, you're stuck carrying the bag. Like, that's how that went down.
I don't have anything to say.
Exactly.
I am done here. I don't want to film with him anymore.
Brianna, I think he has a point, right? His point is not completely invalid, right?
I'm done here. I don't want to finish this conversation. I want to go home. I'm going
reality
home.
Reality can't be spoken of.
I'm going
sure,
home.
Took her earpiece out.
I don't want to do this.
I got on. I got it.
I'm
my
done.
God, I
work I'm,
for
done. This. I'm done. I'm done.
I mean, this ain't no MTV check.
I'm done. Hmm.
Well, all right.
Give me the kisses.
Yay, mommy!
Your mommy good sugars.
No, like this.
Mm-hmm.
It's your birthday!
I love my baby.
The Team Mom 2 reunion. We wanted to end this season by talking to some of the TM2 kids, so please give a warm hand to Kailyn, Lincoln, and Isaac, Leah, Allie, Addie, and Gracie. And of course, we have Chelsea.
Chelsea!
Hi!
What happened? Where's Aubrey?
So we went back and forth, and I just didn't want her to feel like she had to do it, and she didn't want to. I think she gets shy.
Or is she too cool for us now?
I mean, probably too cool.
Yeah, that's probably what it is.
Oh. And Addie, I understand you had an important question for me. No? All of a sudden, was it for Gracie? Okay.
Okay, first I have to ask you, are you flexible?
What?
Not really.
Can you do a cartwheel?
Not really.
You can't show us one.
Well, I would hurt some audience members if I attempted
this here. He might blow his knees out.
I would hurt myself, but I would also hurt other people here more importantly, so.
She was like, I'm putting this in my notes that I will tell him anything he wants to hear if he does a cartwheel. That's what she said.
Oh, well, if we get stuck on something, I may have to do a couple cartwheels.
Okay, are we gonna get with the cards or something like that?
Yeah, we're going to do these cards.
Addie's
yeah.
ready.
Oh, yeah. You want to get to it.
Let's
I see.
Let's go, guys.
Because I'm not staying here for long.
I'm with Addie. Let's get going.
How about Hawaii? How was that experience?
I got to swim with dolphins.
Wow.
I saw them, but they didn't swim underneath me like they did Momo.
Did you pet it?
No.
No.
Would you?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that's so sweet. Well, Gracie, are you still doing cheer?
Uh-huh.
How's it going?
Good.
Are you having lots of fun?
Yep.
Great.
And Allie, camp, so cool, right? What was your favorite part?
Getting awake away from my sisters.
Wow.
That was me.
We all need a little break sometimes.
Yeah, I enjoyed those weeks too.
And swimming.
And Isaac, you're still in jujitsu, right?
Yeah, me.
Both you are. Anybody want to show us anything
to
learn?
Lincoln, do you know a cool move?
We both want to do something not related to jujitsu.
Okay, go ahead.
They want to dance.
I want to see it. I want to see it. Can do it.
Yeah.
Do it.
I bet y'all can do it with them.
Come on. I have this thing. I don't know what to do.
Okay, here we go.
Come on, Lincoln.
I knew it.
You need music?
I'm doing it.
Yeah, music.
Do the floss?
Oh, God, yes.
Oh, yeah. Now, Aubrey's playing softball, right?
Yep.
What softball. Position does she play?
Well, they're kind of at the stage where they switch around.
Okay.
But she really likes to be catcher, and I was a catcher, so it's kind of...
Oh, nice.
And Lincoln, what was your favorite part about being on vacation with everybody?
You were so hyped to do this reunion, and now you don't want to talk? How about the pool?
Oh.
Or the luau. Y'all were really, really pumped about the luau, huh?
Mm-hmm. For them to lock us out.
Someone cutting coconut opened by a tree.
Whoa.
And then I drunk. We were big on good.
Was that your favorite part of the trip?
Nope.
What was your favorite part?
We tried to lock mommy and the parents out of the house.
Whoa. Did it work?
We didn't do it because we thought it was going to get deep.
Doo-doo. Oh, yeah. Doo-doo. Deep doo-doo.
Okay, so we do have some questions from the fans. Hi, what's your name and what's your question?
Hi, my name is Nicole, and my question is for all the kids. What do you want to be when you grow up?
Ooh, that's a big question.
Isaac?
I want to be a paleontologist and a singer.
Oh.
Nice.
Lincoln?
Scientist that makes potions.
Makes potions.
Wow.
Gracie?
A model.
Model.
Nice.
Maddie?
A teacher.
Teacher.
I love teachers.
I don't know.
Don't know yet.
Still thinking okay, about it. Do you know what Aubrey wants to be when she grows up, Chelsea?
A dolphin trainer.
I think she said that last time.
Committed.
Yeah. Committed. Thank you so much. So, Addie, do me a favor, okay? You're going to look at the next person and say, hi, what's your name and what's your question? Go ahead, Addie.
Hi, what's your name and what's your question?
Hi, I'm Amanda, and my question's for Isaac. Isaac, who would you consider your best friend from the show?
Just spit it out already.
Goodness.
Excuse me?
Just spit it out already.
Can I say my mom?
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. Aww. That is so sweet.
Isaac, who's your second best friend?
Lux. And Lincoln.
No.
I want to squeeze Lux's cheeks. That is so cute.
You like to squeeze Lux's cheek?
Yeah. They're pretty squishy, I can tell you.
How's he doing?
He's good. He's really good. But
he's two, right?
Yeah, and he loves being around all the kids, so. And he doesn't mind when Addie squeezes his cheek.
Isaac, I understand you had an important question for me.
Yeah. Why are you so funny on your podcast and not at the reunion?
That's a good question, because this isn't the environment for that. That's a different environment, and it's with comedians. Thank you for asking, though. I'm not sure your mom should have you watching that podcast.
After this, can I give everybody a high five?
Yeah. Is that okay with everyone? I think that would be so awesome.
All right, with that, we've reached the end of another incredible season of Teen Mom 2. From Nessa and myself, we thank you for watching, and we'll see you next year.
Give me the kisses.
Yay, Bobby!
Your mommy good sugars.
No, like this.
Mm-hmm.
It's your birthday!
I love my baby.
Walk off, walk off.
That's,
I'm telling you, okay. I'm telling you.
Ash, are you serious?
We gotta support each other. We gotta support.
No. When have I not supported you?
Let's give a warm welcome to Leah. Kayla. Chelsea. Bar. Joe. Brittany.
As close as they can possibly.
For what?
Just we want everybody to be safe and everything to play fair. Just want everything.
We're gonna have fun. This is Unseen Mamas, show. For Christ's sake.
No,
this is
a not fun.
What are we?
I'm good. How are you doing?
Good. Nice seeing you.
I'm done that way.
No, it's
all right, ladies and gentlemen. Here is Brianna.
And welcome back. I'm still here with Maci, and we are now joined by Ryan's wife, Mackenzie. Now, Ryan could not be here in studio with us today, and Mackenzie's going to give us an update of where Ryan's at right now.
He's getting the best help that he can right now. He's doing great. He's in a great place. Things are really looking up.
He's in treatment.
Mm-hmm.
Fantastic. That's excellent. Let's get into this. How did everything sort of come to light and you got him to go to treatment? How'd that happen?
I mean, I just kind of figured out some things and I confronted him about it.
What were the options you gave him?
I told him, you know, that I loved him, but I couldn't sit by and watch him kill himself. Right. And so when he was ready to get help, to please let me know.
And so you were out, you left.
Mm-hmm.
What are you thinking?
I mean, that is horrifying to see.
Have you seen him like that before?
Mm-hmm.
Had you ever confronted him before about his drug use?
The first time he actually came to me and he got help and it lasted not very long.
So there'd been a previous treatment.
Mm-hmm.
And did you know about that? The previous treatment?
Now.
You didn't know about it before.
Mm-mm.
Did you ever think about telling Mackenzie about that?
I didn't feel like it was my place to tell her.
Let me get back to what I was talking to Maci about before you came out here, which was that she had a lot of conflicted feelings about talking to you about this.
Right. Well, I actually wrote a letter, an open letter to Maci, because I'm really bad about like coming up with things on the spot and not.
Would you like to read that letter?
My mind. So yeah, I would.
Let's have her read the letter, okay? Okay.
Maci, you told me to my face merely days after I had informed you of Ryan seeking help that you had known about his problem since November. That was 186 days, 4,464 hours, and 267,840 minutes that he could have died, and still you said nothing. You let everyone know you feared for his life while concurrently exploiting Ryan and his addiction on the show. I had only known...
I didn't exploit Ryan.
I'm
he
not finished, no.
Himself.
Let me finish.
I didn't
I'm not finished.
Him. He did.
I had only known about it for 2 days before Ryan was walking into treatment. You preach about hating complacency and enabling, but because you turned your head to the problem, that makes you the enabler, not everyone else that it's blamed on. This is not reality television. This is actual reality. Instead of solving the problem or doing what you could to make an effort to solve it, you decided to humiliate Ryan, humiliate myself and his entire family, but more importantly, you've humiliated our children for years to come. Helping Ryan doesn't mean talking about all of his problems on national television. It means being supportive, not kicking someone when they're down, and respecting the privacy that we all so graciously deserve. I mean, it's not funny.
That, yeah, I think it's ridiculous.
Yeah, it's ridiculous that no one knew, Maci, and you had all the information.
We talked about how conflicted you were about the whole thing.
Mm-hmm.
Do you want to express your feelings about this?
Nope.
You're shutting down.
Well, I mean, she talks about privacy. Don't sign up to be on a TV show then. And I didn't exploit you, your husband did.
Maci, you went to Puerto Rico and exploited it. You could have easily come to me before talking about it on the show and talk to me about it. That's exploiting. Yeah, that it is.
No, it's not.
Okay.
Can I, Mackenzie, can I ask something?
Get out of my way right now.
I think we ought to see if we can get her back here. Because for me, I'm sorry, Maci, the thing that concerned me the most is that she feels humiliated.
I did not humiliate Ryan. Ryan did that. He's clearly in a very bad state on the show. Everyone knows about it. Everybody sees it.
Okay, so you have a therapist, you have the interventionist, and the interventionist, is that the one you spoke to on the phone that we saw you on the show? Okay, they did not advise you to go talk to Mackenzie, though, did they?
He kind of agreed that that probably wasn't going to work.
All right, my understanding is Mackenzie is available backstage. Can we invite her back out? Sure. Mackenzie, want to come on in? Okay. So thank you for coming back. I appreciate it. Did you hear what she was just saying? That, you know, she was being coached up by an interventionist in a certain direction. Does that change your feelings at all?
No.
No. How are you feeling, by the way? You walked off.
I just needed to collect myself.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Do you want to explain to Mackenzie why you didn't?
She was watching back there.
I mean, I just don't really want an excuse. It's, if you didn't, okay, that's fine. We're here now. We're in treatment. We don't need to go back there.
Yeah.
But you just went back there with that letter you had.
I got to tell you, it's not that uncommon for people to have information and take some time to figure out what to deal with it.
I can't believe that you would see any scene around Ryan's problem and ever think that that was me talking.
I mean, there are many lives here, you know, being affected by this one illness.
Right.
You got to get on the same team. Not today, I get it. It's all right. And the resentments and whatever, they're all sort of you say her letter's I say, all this is.
You guys made a promise to Danae about him always being in the baby's life, and you guys are now going back on the promise.
Okay, so I kept my word. I did. I told him that I would let him see Brayson even if we broke up. And I did. I kept my word. And I let him see him. In the entire night that I let him have him for overnight, I had calls constantly. I can't make this baby stop crying. What do I do? He couldn't take care of this baby. And then I find out the next day that he got drunk with my son there.
Can I speak about that night? I'm so sorry to interrupt.
Sure. But
so that night you dropped the baby off. We were all there. Danae was not drunk. And he did go through a crying spell. Like, we didn't know what was wrong with him at this point. So Danae was calling Brianna. She didn't answer her phone at all. And your son was at our house. She's so concerned about his safety. But we were calling you to try to get
I
you.
I did answer.
Can I finish, Brianna? Don't
said,
be rude.
I want to talk to you.
Don't interrupt.
Right.
I'm talking. Since when did you become so rude? Why are you so angry towards me?
I'm not angry.
You acting
I'm
like it.
I'm angry because you're trying to defend him when he told
I'm telling you
that
what was happening
drunk.
When I was
he
there.
He personally said to me that he was drunk
that night. But I'm telling you,
night.
I was there. I'm telling you, the baby was there.
So I don't know
there.
Why he would say that he was
because
drunk that night.
Because obviously he said that you guys were supposed to talk. So he was trying to get you over to the house.
Exactly.
Yeah, no, he told me that when I was at work and I answered the phone.
No. Oh, my God.
You did tell me that.
Now you're talking about it's like, oh, my God.
So back on that night, so the baby was fine. Asking Danae to call Brianna to figure out when Brianna was going to come back and get the baby. Calling Brianna, calling. No answer. Nothing at all. So finally the next day, Jessica comes and pick up Brayson. And then come to find out, like, you know, we see on Facebook or Snapchat, she out with another dude, hanging out, taking pictures and hee-hee-ha-ha, but you can't even answer the phone for your baby, and you're so concerned about
his. That's a lie.
It's not a lie.
Now you're lying. No, now you're lying. I would not answer the phone for my baby. I answered the phone for my baby. And no, and every time, shut the f*** up. Every time, you told me. No, you told me. No, because you told me, I just want to talk to you. I just want to talk to you. Because you're lying. I'm not lying. Lie to your mom all the time.
Guys,
oh my God,
lying.
Get out of my face. Like, I would not answer the phone for my baby. That's why you don't see my baby anymore.
How do you realize that you switched because you have so much hatred towards me? What did I do?
Because, dude, you want to lie to her? Really?
How am I lying?
I answered the phone every time, and every time you're like, oh, you're a dumbass whore.
Yes.
You're
yes.
one of those guys. Yes. Shut up!
Really?
Guys, let's one at a time.
I'm done. I don't. I'm not doing this anymore.
No, done.
I'm done.
I understand.
I'm done.
Bye.
You want to lie? Go be a liar somewhere else.
You're the only liar here, bro.
Yeah, shut the up, dude.
gosh.
That's the real Brianna. So it's not just Danae with the anger issues.
You know what? Anybody that has to sit here and listen to all the lies, everything you just said was a lie.
You were living in my house, Jessica.
Why
is everything a lie? There's no truth.
I don't know. Why are you lying about everything?
It's not the truth. That's your thought, your opinion of me.
When you're ready to have an adult conversation, grow up, Danae.
Seriously.
Bye, Jessica.
So that was a lot.
I'm trying to just stay calm.
It's emotional. This is our first time seeing them, and you know,
I didn't even expect that much.
Me either. Me either.
That hatred is too much, bro.
It's hard. I understand.
Do you think it's fair to judge someone on first impression?
Yeah, I do.
What if somebody were to see you in the one of the fights you have with Joe or Javi mm-hmm. and judge you for that?
Yeah.
I think that's
They're not in the situation, though.
I'm just saying, is that appropriate for people to judge just based on a single observation?
I see what you're saying, mm-hmm. but this is my son, and this is the person that is going to be around him for mm-hmm. a while.
So I think you'd want to know more, because he's going to be around him for a while.
Where are you getting at here?
Trying to, for you to see V as a human being, as a person. No, you don't. You see a cartoon character who was online posted with a...
Are you in the situation?
This.
You guys all suck. Get me the here. I'm done. You guys
all okay.
I'm sorry.
That's all right. Listen, it's not my intention to upset Catelynn. It is the Teen Mom 2 finale special, a checkup with me, Dr. Drew. Our teen mom, Kailyn, is back on stage, and we are joined now with the man we saw her marry this season, Javi. Welcome.
Thank you.
Javi, now, you and I had to have a little tete-a-tete.
Yeah.
So you left the stage. You were upset.
I was upset. I just felt like I was being attacked, and I just feel like I'm entitled to my own feelings, and I just don't like someone, and it happens to be Joe's girlfriend.
And you felt as though I was really intruding on that privilege.
Kind of, yeah.
Yeah, and that I was supposed to be on your side, and you felt like I wasn't enough on your side. And I apologize. It's not my intention at all. Mm-hmm. How did you feel, Brianna, when Jade flipped over?
But it would have been anybody.
I was happy for her.
Way.
I really,
not just you.
I think that her story is great, and I think it was just amazing for her.
Ashley, any thoughts?
No
thoughts?
I have thoughts on my own business.
So your own business, meaning...
I had no feelings. I got a bunch of calls about it. They told me they were going to move her. The article, I knew it wasn't an issue. It spiraled into some issue, but it really wasn't. I knew before it got leaked on the internet.
You'll have to forgive me. I just don't know anything about this. What escalated?
Rumors, Dr. Drew.
Basically, just a bunch of rumors.
There was rumors that it was between Ashley or Jade to come to two, and then it evolved and escalated into...
me lying about it and being jealous, and it just was a whole, like, escalation of things.
Have you and Jade talked about this?
No.
And Jade, how do you feel?
Let's just cut the You accused me of lying about being on Teen Mom 2. I didn't lie about it. I was actually asked if I wanted to go. I said I'd rather stay with YP. I was more than supportive of your move to Teen Mom 2. Until you said what you said, I felt shaded by that because, first of all, I don't have to lie.
I didn't say to
No, you didn't say because you don't have the balls. What you did was...
Why did you walk off?
Girl, when you posted yesterday about me and Bri online, we did not exclude you. Okay, first of all,
Kayla,
let's sit over here. Let's just cut the whole entire. Let's cut the. Don't walk up on me. You bitches act like it's me that's the problem. I'm not the mother. Problem. I reach out to you about Brayson, do I not?
Yes, you do.
Hell, I reached out. I've never been anything but loving to you. Rachel,
the feeling is mutual.
I said, people are going to judge you, but baby, know who you are. You're beautiful. What? Kaya, what did I say to you? I said, welcome to the show.
Bye.
Whatever you need.
Bye, Nessa. See you later.
Ew.
You're cool with Jade after she said you were a dumb slut for getting pregnant again? You're cool with Jade after she said that you were dumb because you were a half bitch, half that was her words.
Okay.
And I supported you. I've supported you. And I'm going to continue to support you guys. But I'm not going to play this bullshit game.
What the did I do to
nothing,
you?
Nothing, bitch. That's the point. Because we're...
Me, hey, me beat the dog last night and said, do you want to talk
the dog out of you? All right. I will beat the dog out of you. Stop trying. Okay. Stop trying.
Have a bunch of
no, because y'all want to do this. Women,
I'm not going to fight you. Fight you, my coworker.
And I've done nothing but support bitches. I support all you bitches. Like, you and your two babies. You and all
yeah,
this
yeah,
shit.
I support all you bitches. Right?
Where's the support for me? Y'all want all your support? All y'all dumbass bitches.
Shut up. Talk about such a
liar. Liar.
Can I talk about
let's take a minute. Let's take a minute. Everyone,
they just
take
my off me, man.
Just
I'm out of here, man.
Everybody.
Nessa, it was a pleasure. Drew, it was a pleasure. Take
this off me, man.
I'm done.
I'm done.
Welcome back. We are still talking to Jade, and now we'd like to welcome Sean. Sean, you said something very touching this season, where you said, you know, you mentioned what great friends the two of you were, and then once you started living together and getting romantically involved, something seemed to happen that ended up in you guys fighting. What do you think the root cause is of that?
Me. Just because I have a lot of growing up to do, you know, still trying to not only figure myself out, but, like, figure out how to be a dad at the same time. And
I got to tell you, I have never heard Jade criticize or in any way ask for more from you as a father.
Yeah.
Although, at times, we saw your behavior becoming somewhat erratic as the season progressed. Is there any thoughts about that or what contributed to that?
Drug use, for sure. Definitely contributed to that.
So here's my thing. Yeah, I can tell you're mostly not using, I believe, but I worry that you're not getting the support you need to make it possible to keep not using.
Right. Yeah, I mean, I know we have, like, family counseling set up in the near future, but since, like, COVID and stuff, it's kind of hard to get in anywhere.
The other thing that caught my attention this season was when Jade asked you to do a drug test, oftentimes you found that, like, off-putting. You didn't like that.
Yeah, I just felt like me complying would, in a sense, give her back control, you know?
I get you're describing a feeling, but I don't understand quite where that's coming from.
It's definitely not me, you know? I definitely took the advice from somebody else.
Okay.
Well, Jade and Sean will stick around as we bring Jade's parents into the conversation. Hopefully, we can clear up the hidden camera video once and for all.
What are you talking about?
My mom sent them the video of you stashing a pipe, I guess, in the room, and then they asked me if I would watch it, and I flipped out.
I'm not gonna sit here while your parents sit there and try to discuss this whole thing. I will leave.
You already said you didn't want to watch it.
I already said
I don't want to discuss it with anybody.
I'm not discussing it, I'm not watching it, we're not talking about it, period. You doing that is just, it's for them to use,
like,
and take advantage of
it. We love Sean now, but the only reason I did is because he lied about finding one before, and it pissed me off.
Okay, but I'm saying y'all all were not innocent, though. That's my whole point.
Welcome back. We're still here with Jade, and unfortunately, Sean walked off, but joining us are Jade's parents, Christy and Corey. Nice to see you all together.
Hi.
Hey. So, Jade, where is Sean, and will he be coming back?
He probably won't be coming back. He stepped outside. I guess he also, like, had no idea about, like, a video being sent in, so he was kind of blindsided by that, and his feelings were kind of hurt. He was upset, so he just decided to end it there and finish.
Christy and Corey, do you have any thoughts about it, or do you want to share anything to set the record straight so we can all move on?
Well, I just want to apologize for sending it, first of all, because people do stuff that they're, you know, at the heat of the moment, live and learn, I guess, you know. Yeah. I wish I hadn't, so I apologize to Sean. I mean, the good thing from it is, and that's all I want to address today, is we've come up from there, you know, so.
The conversation you had with Leah was super nice, but I think Christina could have said a bit more than I'm a bonus mom.
I'm pro your relationship with Leah.
And maybe...
I know you are, but I just think that sometimes I get pushed
to the side, obviously, she just said it.
You're right in the sense that these are very, very touchy, emotional, hot button issues. And of course you have lots of feelings about it, of course. And I think Christina would understand that. So let's not let that blow up into something. It's let's just say, of course, this is tender stuff.
I'm gonna do this. Listen.
Yeah.
I'm gonna stop this right now because we're gonna end this. I'm gonna end this on a positive note. Thank you, Gary, so much for that. I really enjoyed seeing that. That was amazing to actually hear you sticking up for me. But your wife is absolutely horrible.
No.
And I have been so, thank you guys so much.
That's not even
Gary, I appreciate you. You know it. We've known each other for how many years? 15 years now. And I'm going to tell you right now, you are a great person. You have always been there for me when I've asked you to be there for me. You said I could trust you, and I did trust you, but I can't trust your wife. And she has sat there, and she has sat there and gotten in the way of me and my daughter over and over and over again as you have tried to push me towards my daughter. So
she's
I'm going to go ahead and leave.
Your daughter.
Thank you so much, though, honestly. You have a good day. I really hope in the future that we can have a good relationship, but me and Christina, it's not going to be like that.
Okay.
So.
That's unfortunate.
Yeah. She's feeling she's like losing her child to Christina or something, or diminished by Christina's relationship with Leah in some way. And, you know, it's work in progress, right? I do think that a professional in here would do you guys a lot of good. What are you doing for work these days?
I just started working again, Bonefish Grill, serving.
Are you okay if Brianna asked for financial support?
Absolutely. Okay. She said $250 a month. So far, I've spent $1,800. How many months in are we? I mean, like since? Let's just keep looking forward. Things are different now.
But now that you're able to do it, you should do it because the last time you helped financially as far as a bill was a while ago, was a few months ago.
If you wanted to put me on child support and I would stay the same person I am. I would treat you the same way. I would still be there for Stella. If you want to do that, you can do that. I don't mind that. Do that. If that's what you feel like you want to get a number set, do that, please.
Every time we speak about financial situation, like you get so offensive, but...
Because it took a long... I took the end of the stick for a long time. You've been rocking Louboutins.
Because I can.
I understand.
I can.
Because of this, because of what? Not because of your 9-to-5.
It doesn't matter.
Yes,
it doesn't matter. Because at the end of the day,
you have been able to provide for so long because of this. I can do it now. I can go drop a bag on over now.
But you
can go take her.
Let me talk.
Let's hear it. You don't have to speak.
Shut the up.
Get respectful, please.
Shut the up. No, I cannot. I can't. Because you're not even listening.
Oh, my God. This is a reunion for us to talk.
Okay,
you've talked a lot. You said a lot more words. Is there a word count here? She said a lot more words than me.
Shut up.
Let me get my words
out.
Shut up. Let's take
shots. I said what I had to say. I'm getting paid now. Thank you. Let's get it.
Every time we speak about money, he gets so flustered about it. Listen, I've been taking care of Nova before MTV. Let's remember, Teen Mom 3 canceled for a while, and I had my 9-to-5 job. Who the f*** was taking care of her then? Not MTV. Me. Me. And the thing is, I could buy these shoes because guess what? My kids' bills are paid in advance, ahead of time. I'm never late on my bills. You can buy a $500 pair of jeans, but you can't do anything else for Nova besides buying her a pair of sneakers.
Do you not
do what you need to do as a father. You do bare minimum, bare minimum.
Y'all let me know
bare
not to talk.
Minimum. You're not a real man.
So that's the court. I'm glad
you're not a real man.
Listen, I don't
I'm
give
sorry.
A flying okay. about how you feel about
I'm
me. That's
sorry.
Okay. That's okay.
Guys, like I said,
it's all about how Nova
good spinning pop here. Bottles in the club.
I don't pop no bottles in no
shut
club.
Up.
I'm not going to the
I
club.
Have
I go places with my girlfriend.
Shut up.
What are you talking about?
Liar, liar.
Can I talk about
him? Let's take a minute. Let's take a minute. Everyone, just take a
mic off me, man.
Just
I'm out of here, man.
Everybody.
Nessa, it was a pleasure. Devine. Drew, it was a pleasure. Take this
mic off
me, man.
I don't want you to go.
I'm done. Take this off me. Done. Congratulations. I'm done. Get this mic off me, bro. I'm done talking. Get the mic. I'm about to go to my girl and enjoy New York City, man. Get off. Damn, there was people here.
It was good to start,
hey,
right?
Anybody else want
to
start? Talk about you?
We can't. Listen, we can't talk.
It doesn't have to be that way.
It doesn't have to be that way. And me, being the kind person that I am, I don't put him on child support.
Well, maybe you should. Maybe that he just told you to do it. Maybe that would create the structure.
You're right.
And we have now him on tape asking you to do that.
No, when I spoke to the lawyer, I also spoke with Devon about the whole situation, and I spoke to the lawyer, and the lawyer said the best thing to do is both establish paternity, put him on child support, yeah. and take it through the courts,
yeah.
which is the right thing to do.
Correct.
And I totally agree with it. Yes. But at the same time, it's like, why do we have to go there?
I don't know, but I'm just arguing with her. I don't want to argue with her.
I know, but then you just sometimes you just gotta shut up.
Don't let your past invade into this present situation. Regardless of the math, you are very lucky to have him.
Of course, I love him. I love him, and I love the fact that he loves the girls.
You can't talk. You're talking to a brick wall. You can't do that.
It's me and him just clashing. We can't yes. get over it, and this is why we're here.
This is not about him. This is about the two of you.
Of course. I okay. know that. I know that.
All right.
We want to bring Jen and Larry into this conversation to talk through some things. So please welcome Jen and Larry. Now, Jen and Larry, are you spending enough time with Bentley lately?
We would obviously love to spend more time with him, but we understand that he's got school, sports, friends, all of that. So
right.
it's okay.
Hey, Larry, can I ask you about that tabloid interview?
Which one?
The one we saw this season where you seem to be blaming Maci for limiting the visits with Bentley.
She's limited some, sure. I don't know if I'm blaming her for it, but yeah, I think she's, you know, some of the things that are going on.
Taylor, you have any thoughts?
Since I've been around, I know this woman has been over backwards to make sure that Bentley kept a relationship with them through everything that Ryan has put us through.
Larry, I wonder if you want to say anything about this.
I got nothing to say.
Larry, one of the things we saw this season is you say something to the effect of Maci putting things in Bentley's head and sort of turning him against, I think you were talking about Ryan at the time. Do you think she does that?
I didn't say against.
Okay.
What I said is that a 12-year-old boy can be manipulated.
Yes.
That is what I said. That is what I thought. Is there any more you want to know about it?
I mean, there's a lot of tension in the room over there. Is this a relationship we can kind of get back together again?
Watching this show and kind of hearing and seeing how they were feeling, and it was kind of shocking to me. I did not realize that the feelings and believing of, like, me manipulating Bentley or us manipulating Bentley, I did not know that existed. Like, I didn't know that that's how y'all felt.
You know we're caught in the middle.
Mm-hmm.
You know how much we love Bentley.
Mm-hmm.
And you know how much we want to support Ryan, mm-hmm. his recovery. And it's so hard. I mean, if you put yourself in our place, and if Bentley had a problem down the road, I know for a fact that you would do everything in your power
to
support
absolutely.
Him.
And I don't.
And you wouldn't want to give up on him.
Oh, no, absolutely.
You wouldn't turn your back on him.
I don't think that y'all should. I've never thought that should happen or even wanted you to.
Hold on. You said that we put him in an unsafe situation. Let me tell you something.
Never would happen.
Never would that ever happen. Ever.
Calm down.
Are we sure?
Don't you think buck up that I've done?
Don't you buck
don't
up to
do
me.
It.
Look,
calm
I'm going to tell you.
Tell me.
Taylor, relax.
What we did and when.
Stop.
When you're forcing him.
Stop.
When y'all are showing up to something.
Stop.
And you're telling
Larry,
him.
Stop.
Go over there and give your dad a hug. Go take a picture with your dad. Bentley is a child.
I'm glad you said
stop
that.
Forcing,
remember that.
Stop forcing.
Remember that.
A relationship on the child. Stop guilt-tripping him into...
We don't guilt-trip him, buddy.
You gonna let me talk?
Yeah, go right ahead.
Ryan's never been there for him. Ryan has never been there for him. But y'all put it on Bentley. Y'all make Bentley feel guilty.
Let me tell you where were you at in the first 3 years of his life?
He lived in Texas, but it wasn't like Ryan was around either.
Okay, stop.
Hang on, guys. Hang on.
All right, listen.
Go ahead, leave here and call a tabloid again.
Taylor,
you know what? I'm sorry,
Taylor, I'm not doing this.
Come
you
on.
Need to step back. Taylor. Taylor. Stop.
You, ain't
you
worth
need
it.
To step
you're
back.
Sorry, son of a bitch.
Stop.
Oh.
Excuse me?
You heard me.
Stop. Taylor.
You heard me.
You
Taylor,
need to step back.
This is not putting the kid
you
first.
You need to step
this
back.
Not, this is not putting Bentley ahead of
exactly.
your guys' feelings.
You're
right,
not
but
putting
I'm sitting
Bentley
here.
First.
I just sit here and watch their piece
what?
Of crap
we
son.
Have,
We no, have been there for Bentley. And you don't know.
This is exactly what happened
5 years.
3 years ago when you called him up on the phone and you used that mouth of yours.
Oh, when he said, oh, can you put a bullet in your head?
Do you want to hear my recording?
I got it recorded. You want me to play it right now?
Taylor, stop, guys.
Go ahead. Let's play it.
Play it, Taylor.
Let's go.
Play it.
Play it.
We already did for the judge. Do you think a judge would give an order of protection? He pled guilty.
Come on.
It was a plea deal.
You are not putting Bentley first in this.
You ain't either when you guilt trip him.
I don't ever guilt trip him.
She hadn't guilt tripped him?
Ever.
Taylor. That is absolutely not true.
Ever.
That's not true, Jen. We all know that that's not true.
That's fine.
Worthless.
Larry, stop.
When you say things.
Who is they, we?
You.
And Jen.
What do I say? You tell me what I say.
What did we say?
When y'all say things like.
What?
Oh, your dad, we can't have a party without your dad. It's Bentley's birthday party. It ain't Ryan's birthday party. Put the kid first. Stop putting that sorry excuse of a human being first.
It's hurt.
All right.
Worthless.
Oh, my God.
All right.
Okay.
A lot of hurt, a lot of misunderstanding here.
It seems like they're the ones that are hurt.
Yeah. Well, you guys are hurt, too.
Yeah, for our son. Nobody else gives a how he feels.
Tell your coward of a son come sit on the couch next year. He wants to run that big mouth.
This is going to sound like almost silly, Larry and Jen, but I wondered if you watched the footage of this season, at least you'd understand what they're kind of reacting to. Some of the stuff you don't see that Ryan says about Maci that's pretty, well, terribly harsh. Terribly harsh.
Okay, so this season or 10 years ago?
No, this season. No, right now. Right now.
And you don't think that they don't say things?
About us?
About Ryan?
And
after
Ryan?
After that mouth right there, you saw it? Now you know why I think that he could be manipulated?
All the time. It's all our fault. All the time.
No, I don't think that they... I was surprised to see what Taylor did. I'm surprised Maci left.
Yeah, I'm very surprised at that.
Dr. Drew, I was wondering if there's a way you can take what you heard from Taylor and maybe explain it in a way that Jen and Larry can receive that.
What I saw... That.
Listen. Yeah, yeah. Let me tell you
I
this.
I mean, right
you
here,
don't
this
have
is like
to explain
off
anything
the charts
to
right
me.
Here.
Okay.
All right?
All right.
Not one damn thing.
Okay.
You know, they talk about how they bend over backwards. Let me tell you something. We have swallowed some crow.
We have kid. Oh, my God.
You have no idea.
Okay, just stop.
I am stopping.
Just stop.
I'm stopping.
Welcome back to the Teen Mom OG reunion. It's time to show some love to the men, so we've brought all the dads and one soon-to-be dad together. Tyler, Gary, Taylor, Josh, Corey, and Zach. It is so great to see you all today. And we rarely have the dads together at the reunion, so this is a real treat.
So, Zach, how does it feel to be joining all the other guys as a father on this program?
It feels great, honestly. I'm excited for this journey. I just can't wait for him to be here, honestly. And I'm just blessed to be in this position right now.
Taylor, how do you think Zach will do as a dad?
Oh, I think he'll do great. I mean, he's sitting right next to a great dad.
Ah, my boy. I appreciate it. Thank you, Taylor.
Josh?
Yeah, I think you'll do good, man. I had no idea that he was even expecting, so congratulations.
Thank you, man.
And Zach, you know, being a father is one of the most wonderful things that happens in life. You've heard all the other fathers talk about it that way. It's also terrifying. Yeah.
Each of the other dads will take turns telling their best fatherhood horror story. So, Gary, since you're the true OG dad, why don't you go first?
Oh, let's see here. I mean, there's some. It's hard to really pinpoint a good one. I remember coming home from work, and Leah was crawling on the floor. And all of a sudden, I see her, like, start climbing and, like, eating kitty litter.
Ooh.
And there was obviously, yeah, there's stuff in there. So I had to, like, I kind of picked her up like almost upside down and put her face near the bathtub faucet and put water in her mouth to rinse it out.
Wow.
So that was pretty. That was a horror one. Yeah.
Okay, how about That's you, funny. Ty?
The biggest horror one for me was when Nova was little, I was just playing with her after feeding her and I was just holding her up in the air, you know, and trying to be a loving, awesome dad and spit. And it just landed right in my mouth. Like, the aim was, oh, man, listen. You just got to be keep on your toes, man, because it's going to get crazy.
Oh, my God.
Wow. And Taylor, your turn.
Yeah, I think Jade was, she was about a year old, and we had some friends in town, and we had gone to eat. And it was a place that served crawfish. So Maci was like, she told me, she said, rub it on her arm, and in a couple minutes, if she breaks out, you know, you'll know if she's allergic to it or not. So we fed her crawfish, and she liked it, and she eats a few of them. So we're driving home. All of a sudden, the most awful smell from the back seat of the truck. And we got home, and she had everywhere, filled the car seat up. I'm talking, we are pressure washing the car seat and the baby in the driveway. Bad.
Okay, how about Corey?
If you haven't heard enough of the blowout stories, I have another story.
Blowouts.
Be ready for them. So when Ryder was little, I took her to the beach for the first time. And I was a new father at the time, so I didn't really know to, like, pack the diaper bag with wipes and a diaper. I'm just thinking, listen, I got the towels. We're going to the beach.
Good.
We're chilling, right? Sure enough, we get to the beach. Long story short, Ryder has a blowout. There's poop all up and down her back. I don't have any wipes. I'm like, listen, I don't know what to do. Yeah. So I see all this water in front of me, and I'm like, listen, the only thing to do is to dip her booty in the water, wipe it clean, and we're going to act like this never happened.
Zach, and now hearing all these stories, are you terrified? Are you excited? Grossed out?
I've kind of been around the blowouts myself. I can't lie. It won't be too new to me.
And fellas, this has been so much fun. Thank you all for doing it. And before we go, we want to share an exclusive sneak peek of next week's Teen Mom 2 premiere. And to introduce the clip, we have the newest TM2 mom, Ashley.
Thanks, Nessa. I'm so excited to be joining Teen Mom 2. I can't give too much away, but check out this special sneak peek from next week's premiere.
Ooh. Watch out, my daughter got a natural talent for it.
I want some ice cream.
I want some ice cream.
I want some ice
God
cream.
Damn.
Sippity sip. Sippity sippity sip.
Come on, yep.
This is cute. It is nice.
So I still got one more present.
Okay.
That I still want to get you.
Sure.
Stand up for me.
No, this is not.
I want to tell you that I appreciate you. You've been with me through a lot. Look at me. And we've been through a lot. And I appreciate you for standing by me. So, I would like to ask you, will you marry me?
Give me the kisses.
Yay, mommy!
Good mommy, good sugars.
No, like this.
Mm-hmm.
It's your birthday! Yay!
Welcome back to the Teen Mom OG Reunion. We are here with Carly's adoptive parents, Brandon and Teresa. It's been a long time since I've seen you guys out on this stage. Welcome back.
Yeah. Thank you. I know, it's like 10 years ago, like this weekend, that we were here for the very first time, right?
Wow. Mm-hmm.
With little baby Carly.
Yep.
Yeah.
Wow.
10 years ago, Kate and Ty made the difficult decision to place their daughter, Carly, for adoption. Let's take a look back at what an emotional time it was for these four.
Hey, Brandon and Teresa. This is
Tyler.
Hey,
Tyler.
Hey, Brandon.
Good to see you.
Hi.
Good to see you.
You're wearing
Hi. When we got married, we started trying to have children and just have not been able to have children. And so, I have just felt for several years that there's a child that we're going to have through adoption, and that's the right plan for us.
I just want her to have better than what I had. And I know that I can't do that. So I'm just doing the thing that I think's the best. And I know that you guys can provide for her a lot more than I can.
Beautiful. Hi, baby girl.
Hi, baby
baby girl.
So tiny.
Sweetie bitty.
So tiny.
Let's see if I can make it through this hug.
So emotional. Oh my God.
I can't remember when I've seen that. I'm like, you guys really know how to bring the tears back. Oh, yeah. Right?
Yeah. Brandon and Teresa, do you remember the first time you got in contact with Kate and Ty?
Oh, sure. I mean, you know, that's the first meeting. I mean, that's the first time we ever laid eyes on one another.
We were so nervous. Me and Kayla, like, oh, hi.
Well, I mean, we were all nervous.
I know, everyone was nervous.
And there were TV cameras.
Yeah. So, yeah.
That adds to this already crazy emotional, you've been building up to this. Oh, my goodness, we're going to meet the birth parents of our baby girl. Then they said, and by the way, they've agreed to be on a show on MTV. And we were like, wow, we did not see that one coming. Scenarios.
Yeah. My question is, a couple 17-year-olds, you imagine they would stay together as a couple?
I mean, look at the clip, and if you go back to 16 and Pregnant, I mean, Catelynn and Tyler were...
exceptional.
You guys were pretty tight and bonded, and so it's not necessarily surprising when we go back to what we think of what we knew of them when we first met them.
I agree with you.
And honestly, the birth father thing is actually, I've learned, Dawn let me know that it's very rare for birth fathers to really... stay involved. Mm-hmm. So most of the time the adoptive parents are dealing with, you know, just the birth mom and the birth father is kind of whatever. So
we're applauding both of you for your commitment to your relationship. We're applauding you, Ty, also.
There you go. Mm-hmm.
You're that exceptional guy.
Agreed.
Yeah.
Okay.
Take it in. It's okay. Brandon and Teresa, can you describe that moment that, you know, when you first held Carly? How was that feeling?
Well, that might make me cry. The feeling any mom has when she first holds her child. I mean, I don't know what you can say other than how amazing that is. And then I'm standing there with this sweet young girl, birth mother, who's handing that child to me. I mean, it's definitely an experience like no other.
Give me the kisses.
Yay, mommy!
Your mommy good sugars.
Who like this? Mm-hmm.
It's your birthday!
I love my baby.
Welcome back to the Teen Mom OG reunion. We're now sitting with Cheyenne and Corey.
Thank you, guys. Thank you. Daddy's here.
Cheyenne spent most of last season trying to work through her feelings with Corey and learning to co-parent with him. They've done a good job raising Ryder together. But this season, she had a new boyfriend and Corey had a new girlfriend. And that led to some complicated emotions.
I'm talking to Taylor again.
I mean, you knew this day was gonna come.
Not with her.
It's just hard thinking of somebody around Ryder that's not us.
Wait, you're making me feel so much more comfortable.
So me and Taylor, we go to Tulum, right?
And I get a text message from Shai saying, hey, Ryder has a fever of 103. I need to get home as quick as possible.
Right.
At the end of the day, he wasn't there. He missed the process. She could go into shock. She can have a seizure. She could die.
I am in a guy.
You're so annoying. What do you think about, like, meeting Corey and stuff?
I don't know. Just gonna kind of walk into it and see where it takes me.
You know what, Corey, the last time I saw you two, there was a different kind of energy between you two. There was like, hey, the hooking up vibe,
right? It was
right?
The mystery energy. We didn't know what to do.
Yes.
Are we together? Are we hooking up? Are we not?
Right? There was a lot of giggling on the couch. Remember that, Dr.
Drew?
I do
remember that.
And now it's separate ways. And now we're in, you know, serious relationships. What happened?
Yeah, I feel like for Corey and I, we want two different things, and I want to get married. I want to have more children. I want to settle down. And he wasn't ready for that. I want something else. And we had to realize that we are really good friends. We're really good co-parents, but we would never be really good mates for each other.
Got it. Corey, were you interested in trying to have a relationship with Shai after that time?
No, I mean, I've stayed pretty consistent on what I've been saying. I never want to lie to Cheyenne. Right. I never want to lead Cheyenne on. At the end of the day, we're just not meant to be right now or whenever, and we just moved on.
And now Corey's in a relationship with Taylor.
Mm-hmm.
I'm hearing mixed feelings when I'm watching it. So where are you at now?
So Taylor and I had a rough beginning.
Mm-hmm.
And social media and past shows haven't helped that relationship. Mm-hmm. But we've sat down, hashed it out. And I've seen Ryder with Taylor, and she's really good with her. So I can't be mad.
Good. So when you were in Mexico and mm-hmm. Ryder had pneumonia,
yeah,
and it seemed like the fans were upset about this. Yeah. They were slamming you online because mm-hmm. you didn't go home.
Right.
How did that make you feel?
I was hurt. At the end of the day, I told Cheyenne this too. I should have been there right away. It's something that me and Cheyenne are working through. It's one of those things where I told her, for me, it's like, get your ass to the hospital. I need you here. Come. I would have been there. So I didn't handle it the way that I should have handled it, I guess. And, you know, it's just one of those steps, me and Cheyenne figuring out this co-parenting thing and just talking about it.
How are you feeling right now hearing this, Cheyenne?
To me, if you're not there in the physical, then you're not going to want to, you're not going to know what to do for the next time. It's not going to be the last time she's hospitalized. It's just, that's just how her condition works. I think when it comes to her condition, it's hard because he didn't see the first 6 months, and that was when it was the worst.
Corey, does her illness scare you? Do you have certain fears about it?
It scares me a little bit because it's hard to look at her and see that she has anything. Like if she has low energy and just the things that we're looking for, you don't know if it's her just being her or if it's actually the VLCAD kicking in or what's going on with that.
You took a big deep breath when he was talking about that. It makes you nervous too, doesn't it?
Oh, I freak out.
Yeah, her and her mom are like.
What's your biggest fear?
That she'll die. Of course, I'm gonna cry. Her condition is scary, and it's 10 times scary because we can't see it. It's not like a scratch or something. You don't know. We just don't know. And I hate not knowing of if she's going to be okay.
It's really rough.
I worry about her constantly. I'm always beating Corey's head of what'd she eat today? What did she sleep? What is she doing now? And it's not because I don't trust him, but I don't trust what she has.
It's hard because I wasn't there for the first 6 months. I mean, when you're there and you see your kid with the IV and you see the heart monitors attached to him, it mentally does something to you.
But even
but
the
I
last
did show
day,
up to the hospital. I showed
you,
up.
When he walked in, he was like, oh, like, you know, then he saw it. But we've been there for 4 or 5 days. It's like, I didn't sleep. I couldn't, Ryder couldn't sleep. So I'm not sleeping. She's not eating. So I'm not eating. It's just hard. It's just feeling as a parent to not be able to feel like you can't protect your child from something. Like, it's just way too much to think about. Oh, my God.
Yeah, you're stressing me out right now.
But
stressing me out.
Thank you so much to Cheyenne and Corey.
Give me the kisses.
Yay, puppy!
Your mommy good sugars.
No, like this.
Mm-hmm.
It's your birthday!
I love my baby.
Welcome back to the Teen Mom OG Reunion. I've come to Indiana to sit down with Amber. Amber, thank you for joining me. Amber was not able to travel to New York due to her pending court case. The recent arrest on charges of domestic battery was the culmination of a difficult season. She raised her baby son, James, with her boyfriend, Andrew, struggled with her bipolar and personality disorders, and learned that her daughter Leah had some anxiety issues of her own. It was a lot to handle, but let's look back at how she did.
He wants you.
You better come give your mom some sugar.
I can tell you, I get bothered by some of the negativity on my Twitter or my Instagram. However, I hit mute or I hit block or something like that. Because if I don't, I will absolutely have another mental breakdown.
Her teacher thought she was having a panic attack on the bus.
Why wasn't I told this? My life. I'm just really crying.
I feel like when something like that happens, you know, you should just let the mom know. Like, this is my daughter. I pray to God that this would never happen to any.
I think what you're going through has less to do with your bipolar illness and more to do with your borderline personality disorder.
I want to hear somebody just tell me there's a cure so I can walk outside and feel happy.
I received a text message from somebody saying that their life and their son's life is in danger.
A text message, by the way. I just want to point that out real quick to everybody. But I ran after him with a machete.
Was he text? The police?
We have a patrol. That's for our area. I'm going to tell you what. If somebody's coming after me with something like that, I'm calling the police and running out the door.
Well, you would think if you were being attacked, you'd want the 911 operator to hear your voice.
Oh, Lord, yes.
Is this all fiction? Is he building some...
There's some narcissism here that I can't comprehend at the moment.
And by that, you mean he's shutting you out in some way that's so cold and so difficult?
I mean, if it takes you less than 2 weeks to ask a woman to come to Indiana.
Oh, he's got somebody else.
Well, I've already talked to her.
Huh. That's pretty crazy.
She's a good person. She's very nice. She's very sweet. She's a very sweet person, but...
So he's trying to cut you out of his life, like Amber doesn't exist. It's just him and his baby.
Well, he keeps telling all the tabloids, oh, it's up to her. Do you not understand what you're doing right now?
I'm guessing this must be particularly painful.
It completely ripped my heart out.
Yeah. I want to go back to something else. I'm a little confused about all this horrible stuff that night. Why don't you tell me the story? What happened?
I can't...
Take us through the evening. You were at some fireworks that night. It was the 4th of July, right?
I'm giving a lot of information right now that I don't know if my lawyers are going to just absolutely hate me for. Because I might actually stop right now because this is getting really intense. Okay.
Okay. Let me back it up a little bit.
Okay.
Tough season.
Let's go, mother...
I was very anxious. I told everyone when we were all in New York how anxious I was to see you and just tell you how much I support you. And we missed you.
I heard it from everybody.
So I'm here.
Yeah,
so here we are.
I'm happy. All right.
Well, let's talk a little bit about the season. How's Leah doing?
Leah's doing really good. I just saw her a few days ago. I mean, she's like 10 going on 14. It's insane.
When you heard she was having anxiety, what'd you think?
I mean, it completely devastated me. It started around that age for me, my anxiety, about 9 years old, actually.
Same symptoms, same kinds? Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Same exact symptoms. I want to be on board with Gary and Christina. I want us all to be on board.
Did he initially embrace the idea of therapy for Leah?
Not necessarily, no. But, I mean, I think we're kind of getting there, I hope.
I think Christina especially knows that.
Yeah, I think we really understand what's needed.
But it seems good now. It really does.
We are good.
So let's talk about how you've been doing since the arrest. Why don't you tell me the story? What happened?
I can't really.
To the extent that you're able.
I really need some assurance.
Yeah. We don't want you to say anything you can't say.
I'm going to talk to my lawyers and just like, just please like figure something
also,
out.
You don't have to
answer. Let me.
Well, I want to get my side of the story out.
Well,
however.
That's what I want. Listen, nobody wants to put you in a compromised situation.
I know.
You know what I mean? This is just like everyone wants to support Amber, including you setting the record straight here.
Like I literally opted out of drug court a long time ago to put myself in prison to help myself. Why would I jeopardize? You haven't heard from me since then. Haven't gotten in trouble one time. But all of a sudden, I'm running after my kid and him with a machete? You're insane.
I appreciate you coming out and being so open. And I know your fans appreciate it. And
I love my fans so much. My beautiful souls.
We'll be back with more of the Teen Mom OG Reunion after the break.
Give me the kisses.
Yay, mommy!
Your mommy good sugars.
No, like this.
Mm-hmm.
It's your birthday!
I love my baby.
And welcome back. We're still here speaking with Amber and Gary.
Well, Gary, I wanted to ask you, why didn't Christina come out to have a conversation and hopefully, you know, hear everybody's side and try to figure this out?
Well, Amber went through some trying times with the courts and everything, and we know she has her mom and her brother, but she doesn't have a lot of support close by, and I understand that, you know? And so me personally and Christina would go out of her way to help her. Well, she decided to, as of recent, try to tell me and Christina that we're all two-faced on her whatever social media platform she decided to use. And one day I went over there and put my arm around her to comfort her, to make sure she felt like she was not alone. And we sat there probably 10 or 15 minutes, and I was nothing inappropriate. But then she wants to go off online before even just saying, hey, Christina, Gary put his arm around me, blah, blah, blah. And she made it turn into this nasty, perverted thing, which it wasn't. And so right now, we're not having this great co-parenting relationship because she wants to twist stuff and make it into something that it's not when it's completely not that.
He needs to stop. I was put in a compromised position in a sense because I literally felt that he was trying to be genuinely nice at first.
Yep.
And it kind of turned into a bit of a touch here and a touch here. And I was like, okay, I'm just starting to feel a bit odd.
Okay. So wait, so a touch on your, hang on, just so I'm clear.
Hold on. He even said to me, 100%, please don't tell Christina that
I put my arm around another girl.
No, that I'm doing this. Yes. Please don't tell Christina that I'm doing this.
Not in this,
so,
but yeah.
Let's say that's what you were doing. What would you have intended? What did you intend?
So the way I feel is I care about Amber. I don't care about her like, oh my God, that's my, I want to be with her in that sense. Because I have a wonderful wife that I absolutely love. If I wanted something else other than my wife, I mean, I told him, I was like, it wouldn't be Amber. We don't have it like that for each other no more. But I was sitting there
on
the couch.
Okay, hold on. And Amber, you thought he was trying to seduce you?
Seduce me? I don't think he was trying to, like, seduce me. But I think he was doing a bit much for somebody who had a girl, for sure.
You were creating a bit of a storm here. Maybe unnecessarily, right?
I think there's a bullshit thing to say to me, Dr. Drew, that I'm starting storm because you weren't there. If you would have watched this, you would have been like, you're not going to touch my wife like that.
That may be. That may be true. That may be absolutely. No, but listen, that's not the point. The point is it seems like it was a mistake. Gary talked to Christina about it. It sent the wrong message to you.
The thing that was created, the storm, I took it down. Like, you need to chill out for your laughing and stuff, honestly, and be a bit more mature. I'm being dead serious.
All right, we're going to move on, okay? Amber has come a long way over the years, and she's worked hard to be, as she puts it, a damn good mom. But recently, the relationship with Leah has gotten tougher. Let's take a look back at that relationship.
Leah, she's hurting a bit.
Be there for her.
I've been there for her, okay? If people
she's
don't,
the age.
People it's don't understand it's that, it's not my problem anymore.
Your child's always going to be your problem.
12 years and she hasn't really done anything. That's kind of been like Christina's spot.
I'm just a bonus mom, though.
I don't want you writing your mom off and saying I can't have a relationship with her, that kind of thing, because, you know, at some point, you should be able to have a relationship with her. I just don't want you missing out on something that could be there, but you know, if you're not letting her come over and you're not letting her spend time with you, then you're never gonna have what you've missed or don't have, you see?
I said, you get a hold of me. I said, I'm here with open arms and an open heart. I said, I love you. I want you to know I think about you all the time.
But what about the pain that she's experienced over the last 12 years when she's had a mom that's been absent for
I wasn't absent at all. And in fact, I took care of her my damn self before I went to prison.
It takes a lot of work to make up for 12 years.
Well, there's Sean again laying it down. How's it feel looking at that, Amber?
The conversation you had with Leah was super nice, but I think Christina could have said a bit more than I'm a bonus mom.
I'm pro your relationship with Leah.
And maybe...
I know you are, but I just think that sometimes I get pushed to the side. Obviously, she just said it.
You're right in the sense that these are very, very touchy, emotional, hot-button issues. And of course you have lots of feelings about it, of course. And I think Christina would understand that. So let's not let that blow up into something. Let's just say, of course, this is tender stuff.
I'm going to do this. Listen.
Yeah.
I'm going to stop this right now because we're gonna end this. I'm going to end this on a positive note. Thank you, Gary, so much for that. I really enjoyed seeing that. That was amazing to actually hear you sticking up for me. But your wife is absolutely horrible.
No.
And I have been so, thank you guys so much.
That's not even
Gary,
true.
I appreciate you. You know it. We've known each other for how many years? 15 years now. And I'm going to tell you right now, you are a great person. You have always been there for me when I've asked you to be there for me. You said I could trust you, and I did trust you, but I can't trust your wife. And she has sat there, and she has sat there and got in the way of me and my daughter over and over and over again as you have tried to push me towards my daughter. So
she's
I'm going to go ahead and leave.
Your daughter.
Thank you so much, though, right. Honestly. You have a good day. I really hope in the future that... we can have a good relationship, but me and Christina, it's not going to be like that.
Okay.
So.
That's unfortunate.
Yeah. She's feeling she's like losing her child to Christina or something, or diminished by Christina's relationship with Leah in some way. And, you know, it's work in progress, right?
Give me the kisses.
Yay, puppy!
Give mommy good sugars.
Go like this.
Mm-hmm.
It's your birthday!
I love my baby.
Welcome back to the Teen Mom OG reunion. It is time now to speak with Amber. All right, Amber, we've seen a lot of growth from Amber over the past few years, and that growth has continued this season. She enrolled in school and worked to repair her relationship with Leah. Unfortunately, Leah wasn't as receptive as Amber had hoped. So let's refresh ourselves about Amber's journey.
When was the last time you spoke to Leah?
It's been a couple months. We already talked about like therapy for Leah alone. Gary wasn't for it at all. Therapy is a good thing to get you and your mother back together, and I think she'll be happier in life.
Amber just sent me a text. I'm going to send you a video for Leah to watch.
I never, ever wanted to hurt you. I will never stop trying to mend our relationship.
I couldn't tell if like, the crying or anything that was fake, so I really don't know what to think of it.
We want to move forward where we can all get along, but I don't want to put like a schedule on anything yet.
Amber had actually reached out to me about going with her to her psychiatrist.
I'm probably gonna go with you on one if you talk to your person about it.
Are you serious?
Well, yeah.
Amber has the diagnosis of borderline personality disorder. Most of them have a history of trauma.
I can now know at least what two of your disorders are, and I understand a little more about it.
You don't really need to say much to Leah right now, but at least you have some more info, like if she has like any questions or anything.
You look a little shut down.
I'm shut down because I'm listening to my daughter say certain things that I see online.
About you.
About the tears, if it's real or if it's fake.
One of the things I've noticed about borderlines is sometimes their emotions feel a little disconnected. And I think that might be what she's reacting to. It's part of the borderline stuff, not really you.
That was the reason for me and Gary to go together.
Yeah.
I just don't want her to write me off like I did, you know, when I was young with my own mother. Mm. Because I know when I grew up, I regretted that. Losing about 4 years.
Have you told her that? Have you told Leah that?
Yeah, I have.
I've seen you evolve so much. Mm-hmm. And seeing how patient you are right now, what made you realize, Amber, that you have to accept where Leah's at?
I was speaking to my psychiatrist, and I started to talk about my past, the abandonment issues with my father, and also my mother, who was working all the time. And I had this sort of hate towards my own father because I didn't understand how he could just leave us. And I felt this must be how Leah feels.
Mm. How's your relationship with Gary these days?
Me and Gary are good. I take him as he is.
Good.
All right, we're gonna bring Gary out. Everyone, please welcome Gary. Hey, Gary. Hello. Good to see you.
Yeah, thank you. It's good to see you guys. It's been a couple years.
It's been a couple years.
So, Gary, after all this time, you finally went to therapy with Amber. I'm surprised that was the first time. That was really surprising to me.
It wasn't a priority to me.
What did
personally.
You learn?
She's got tools to use to kind of keep herself where she needs to be or to help if she's in a situation.
Mm-hmm. You need to learn about the borderline disorder.
Mm-hmm. And that was the one I did learn about. It's like, cause, okay. And I know a little bit about her. Like, if we get into an argument and a minute later, she'll forget about it.
Right. That's the good news. The bad news is there can be a lot of aggression and stuff that comes out of nowhere.
Yeah.
What did you tell Leah about this?
With the borderline personality disorder, the going up and down, like, you know, it sometimes they get so you get depressed where it's like you don't want to go out and do nothing.
You're, right.
You know,
and that's what that particular symptom, which is a symptom of both the bipolar and the borderline, being overwhelmed, being depressed, used to drive you crazy.
Mm-hmm.
You really did not give her a lot of space for that.
Probably not.
Amber, what are you feeling? You're kind of checking out a little bit.
Yeah.
What's going on?
I just think whenever, like, just talking about Leah, I just get a little, just shut down a little bit.
I feel like you're now at a place where you don't have to collapse. Like you got the strength to keep stay present and not let it shut down like that.
Yeah.
So, Gary, don't you think it'd be a good idea for Leah to see somebody too? So she can kind of be brought along with?
She is speaking to somebody, a professional.
Okay.
So you probably didn't know this. Per Leah's request, she didn't want it to be talked about. I have her permission.
Us to talk about it here.
No. So I have permission to talk about it, to make it known and acknowledged. So
Amber, that's good news, right?
Yeah, it's good. You may be going to see about it.
Maybe you'll get in there with her therapist one of these days, too.
I hope that one day when she feels comfortable, that happens.
This is the first time you're hearing about this.
Yeah.
Part of Leah going, she didn't want anybody knowing to start off. And I have supported that. I was like, it's your safe spot. They're working on different things that she can do to help the communication start between her mom and her.
How many times has she gone?
She's gone, I think, about 10.
Oh, goodness.
Here's the thing. I'm the mother of her. I need to understand what Leah is going through, so I believe that the communication should be there for that.
But I also don't want
to... I also think that Leah is a child.
Yeah.
She is not an adult. I am her mother.
So you don't think it's okay for her not to tell you what she's doing in order to help
herself?
No,
she doesn't need to say anything, but you... can tell me.
So when we break her trust and tell you what she doesn't want you to know.
That's not breaking trust, though.
There's been a
that's not breaking
she wasn't
trust.
Wanting to go unless
that doesn't matter.
She felt safe and had somewhere safe to say what she wants. I was trying to let you know. I was given permission
from Leah.
Well,
thank you for letting
me
know on the stage here. I don't need a camera in front of my face for me to know something.
So there was an error, a mistake. From your perspective.
Well, this error and mistake has been going on for years. Every time that I find out something, it's in front of a camera.
And now going forward, it sounds like Leah's going to let you keep Amber informed, right?
No.
Up to her. Like, I'm not even asking her unless she wants to tell me something. Well, I want her to have a safe place where she wants to say something about me.
Why don't you talk to the therapist about what the boundaries should be? Because here's what Amber's position is. You have a child. You're putting the child in charge of the therapy. You don't.
I'm not putting her in charge of it.
I'm just saying. That's what Amber's saying.
Okay, if I were to sit there and say it, you would understand.
You don't do that.
I know, Gary. I understand what you're saying, too.
No, you don't, because you're not listening. Somebody has a plan to do something with you.
It doesn't
and I can't
matter.
Tell you because it's supposed to be private.
Don't start yelling at me.
Don't sit there and put your finger
care.
In my
don't,
face.
Don't start
and act
yelling
like
at me. I don't
thing,
care,
girl.
Honestly.
Just, look,
because
do your
you
thing.
Because you came out here with some bull crap.
Okay.
I just found out on camera, of
all
course.
Right. All right.
Everything that you do is for television.
No, it's not.
Done.
Oh, Jesus.
Okay. Everything that he does is for television. I'm out.
Bye.
Bye.
Okay.
I'm not for it. Live your life. And by the way, your
Here
first
we go.
Class ticket coming back, you're not sitting
That's
with
fine.
Me.
That's fine.
You can't so, use me for the rest all of right. your life and for your money. How do you have your money today, Gary?
All because you think
How do you have your money today?
Because of you think
Please
you.
Tell me.
Hey, bye.
Are you leaving? Are you leaving? Answer the question.
I said thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Thank you so much for everything you've done for me. I appreciate it.
You're okay. welcome. Garbage. Listen, he could keep making his money off me. This is ridiculous. You know damn well that Gary only does this when we have screens. I'm done.
See what's up.
Christina, you want to keep secrets from me? I'm the mother. I would have just liked to know that she was even going. That would have been nice.
Give me the kisses.
Yay, Bobby!
Your mom.
mommy good sugars.
No, like this.
Mm-hmm.
It's your birthday!
I love my baby.
Christina, you want to keep secrets from me? I'm the mother. I would have just liked to know that she was even going. That would have been nice. Just think about if that was your daughter. You know, just think about that.
So it's triggering, like you said, right? And that's okay.
And Christina understands because yeah. me and Christina yeah, yeah. have talked about this before no. when he was against it.
Yeah.
And she wasn't.
Is Leah asked you guys not to share it with mom? Is that what happened?
She just didn't want her to know that she was going yet. They're working on something together, her
yeah,
and her therapist.
That's what I keep hearing Gary saying. There is yeah. a plan.
The 12-year-old child is running every single thing.
The therapist
and
is doing
listen,
it.
I've educated myself too much. I've learned too much. I don't know any therapist in the world that would sit there and say, don't tell the mother that you're going. Especially 10 times. Come on. Everything that I just said.
You want to go sit down back here with all this?
Everything that I just said is what I just, you, is how
come,
I feel.
Come back. Come on. Christina, come on. I'm going to bring Christina in. I'm bringing everybody in.
Hi, Christina.
Yeah.
Hey. Right here. Thank you, Amber, for coming back. Thank you.
Amber has come back. Thank you.
Thank you.
I know it's been very upsetting. Gary, thank you. Christina, welcome.
Thank you.
Christina, we spoke backstage, and I thought it was important to get mom's point of views, right? The feeling of being a mom and not knowing what was going, you got that, you get that feeling.
So as a mother, I mean, yes. Co-parenting, yes, the communication, you know, should be open. But I'm kind of like mixed in the middle. Because I know how Leah has asked, you know, because she wanted to work on the relationship with you. Mm-hmm. But she wanted to do it in private. And I think she wanted you not to know. So that way, when she came back to you, that it was a lot of progress on her part. And, you know, no time was missed between you and her.
You saying it that way is completely different. The reason why that I got hurt is because I just don't feel like hearing about things sometimes on camera, I feel like I want to hear them behind the scenes so I can process it, because I'm trying to let you guys know when it comes to Leah and all the times that I messaged her and tried to get a hold of her and everything, she never responded to me. And I would be just, and when I sent that video, when I heard her say something about the fake crying,
yeah.
it killed me. But if that's the way that Leah felt, that this was a safe place.
She was finally, in case things were brought up, I checked with her. It wasn't just about being a safe place. It was that she was okay sharing it. You got to understand, she is young, and she doesn't know how friends will react knowing about stuff like this.
But we have a new sort of stigma story now, which is Leah's feeling stigma about getting treatment, which
exactly.
is unfortunate. We should be clear that taking care of your health includes taking care of your mental health, and there should be no stigma no. for these things.
Now, earlier in the season, it felt like there was some tension between Amber and Christina. Obviously, this has been a journey.
Yes.
How are things today?
I love Christina, and I respect her today. I think before I was, when I was hurting and I lashed out at her, I wasn't understanding exactly everything that she was doing. And the main reason was what was going on with Leah. I wasn't understanding the shift that happened, but, you know, I think that Leah just came into, you know, she's getting older and she was like, enough is enough, and just let her feelings out, to be honest. And I think that I put that as Christina was doing mm-hmm. something, and it wasn't. It had nothing to do with Christina. It had to do with what Leah was feeling. She was getting older. This is how she feels. You know, I apologized for that, and I'm happy that Christina is in my life, honestly.
Amber, as you look towards the future and your hopes for the relationship with Leah, what do you imagine? What do you want? What does it look like?
This is a complicated situation because this is a blended family, honestly. It's not just Leah, it's James too. Mm. And, you know, they care about James as well. And we can sit here and say we're doing all this for the kids, but we can't sit here and say that we don't have feelings for each other.
Oh, my goodness,
of course.
Human beings. You guys, thank you for coming in. Amber, thank you for coming back. Mm-hmm. Christina, thank you for being such a stabilizing force and listening very carefully. Gary, we love you. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
And this is progress, everybody. Up next, we will talk to Maci and Taylor about Macy's PTSD, the bumps in their marriage, so you do not want to go away.
Give me the kisses.
Yay, mommy!
Your mommy go to sugars.
No, like this.
Mm-hmm. It's your birthday! Yay!
It's because of these girls. I'm sitting on the stage right now. And I just want everybody to know that.
Hello.
Hi.
Hi.
Hi. Amber, Kate, Maci.
Look at your hair.
Cheers.
To a good day, fun only.
Yes. Yes.
No sure. drama.
No drama.
And don't let mother ask us crazy questions, just walk
Amen.
Away.
Ryder, come say hi.
Hi.
I'm engaged.
Oh, no!
Shove it, bling.
Oh, man.
I couldn't keep up with your vows, man, but I tried.
No
way. I love you so much.
Oh, congrats.
Thank you so much for coming.
Oh, my God, I wasn't going to miss it.
It means so much to me.
My best.
How's everything going with you and Ty?
We go to therapy together, like, once a week and stuff. Like, you know, just hitting some bumps in the road or whatever, but that happens. So
yeah, that happens with everybody.
Yeah.
I know, we made it.
Hi. Look at this beautiful lady.
But they're so funny. We're like live.
She's so pretty.
So we're on our way to the studio.
Photo shoot day.
Yay.
Yay. And about a million media questions.
You know, I see all of these women and I think they're incredible, but I don't think they think they are. And a lot of it has to do with social media, people always having an opinion, the mom shaming bull. Like, I just wish they could see themselves the way that I see them.
You know, they always say like the first year of marriage is the hardest, and for me it was true.
Oh no, no doubt about it.
Has it been for you guys
yeah.
too?
Yeah, marriage sure, 100%.
You guys were together for so long.
I know, but really our first year was.
No, our first few months so far have been really rough. I was legitimately pregnant for two years.
2 years, yeah.
So I've had two constant years of hormones and stress and work, and then like postpartum, and then having an 8-year-old.
I'm really worried about Amber Portwood.
She reached out to me and said she was struggling with like postpartum and stuff.
That you came out though, it means a lot to me. It really does. When I got that voicemail from you, you know, it was just, it really hit my heart. I'm not living for myself at the moment, you're asking.
And I would love to see you at a place where you could.
So what was going on? Did anything happen in just life?
Well, no, really. Me and Tyler actually got pregnant.
Really?
And I had a miscarriage.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Taylor and I also had a miscarriage this year.
Oh, you did?
Yeah.
I'm sorry, Maci.
Yeah, it's tough. We haven't told anyone.
How's it feel being like a part of this show now?
It's nerve-wracking coming on a show when people have done it for so long.
Especially
yeah,
for you,
it's
I
so
think.
Different. This versus like, since I did Are You the One, and then I did The Challenge, and then now this is so different.
Yeah, they get to show every single part of your life now.
Yeah.
Literally. Like even the bad parts,
it's
you know
scary.
What I mean?
So scary.
Yeah.
You know, like to say,
what up, are you and Cheyenne together now?
Are we together now?
She just jumped right into that one.
Wait, no, because somebody says something to me.
Oh.
Who told you?
Who said that?
Proposed.
Somebody.
They're both of the...
You
are?
I told Andrew last night, I was like, can you imagine this guy found out that this was his baby and he's like, I'm ready to go. Like, let's go, let's go. There's not many men who do that, like, honestly.
And he came and he showed up. He had gifts for the baby that day. He brought me flowers.
When I see y'all, I just see y'all together somehow. But I think what it is, though, that I see y'all together is because of how you guys talk about your kid together, as if you guys are together. Me and Andrew, like, we're not married or anything like that, but it's working. Like, we don't.
Right. It's like the pressure.
And we all get asked that question. And the scary part is I've been engaged like 4 times and I called it off every time. Because I knew we weren't going to be together. It was something in me that was like, nah, if this man asked me,
this is what.
I'm so scared because, like, I would marry him.
We're just glad we have cast members we can talk to.
Right?
Yeah.
Does everyone have a drink? Should we cheers?
Yeah.
Cheers.
To new relationships.
The new G's. The new G's, yeah. OG's and the new G's.
Yay. Cheers, y'all.